I used it to fend off many evil weapons. Oh.
GeekVerse Gauntlet 1, count them 2, count them 3, count them 4, I'll be there.
Like, whoa, shit, there's a new guy coming into the gauntlet here, like, holy fuck, what are we gonna do?
Oh my god, it is Kirklin Panther!
Yeah. Oh no!
My time, my title, now!
Oh.
All the fans for helping me, the hashtag underground champion, but you know what? Fuck the fans, fuck everybody, all that matters is me, I'm the champion, I don't care who you are, I'm holding this forever, I don't care who I verse, who I gotta go against, that's it, it's over, I'm the fucking man, I don't care if I verse Tyler next, I don't care if I verse Kirklin next, this is mine, and I'm keeping it.
Woo!
Oh! Are you kidding me? Any tips? No! Ladies and gentlemen,
you
fuck!
Yes!
Travis, I mean, this goes to show that even losers can become winners. So don't give up, okay? Whatever you say.
This is awesome.
7 competitors, 6 matchups. They've all been randomized. The winner of this is going to become the number one contender for GeekMania. Reuben!
Wow, what a debut!
Victory for Reuben and Saruman.
Just the end. Wow!
And what a match! Reuben done.
I'm going to say the saltiest thing right now and just say I'm better at video games.
Oh, wow.
And I want to challenge good old D-Mus over here to a unofficial title rematch.
It's at the walls! Oh, she tried to go to the
gauntlet!
Dylan Musk is one!
The Sports GeekVerse Gauntlet Championship. Winner is going to GeekMania and getting a shot versus a mystery opponent.
I feel like it's going to be a very even match. I'm really actually going to give it my all to win this.
He actually said that he wanted me to pass something along to you.
I screwed up Taylor once before by helping Travis take control of the gauntlet. I'll screw him up again by taking this title.
Seriously, what the fuck?
So now, before we move on, You know, I haven't been counting, but at least half of like the title matches that have happened in the Geek vs. Gauntlet. And
it's true.
You haven't even given me a match for this Mania.
Well, then what do you want? What do you want?
I'm going to do your job for you, and I would like to challenge good old D-Mus over here to a unofficial title rematch.
I'm super upset about the fact that way back when, in the first title match, I lost to him.
I look back at the first ever gauntlet, and, you know, just game after game,
but right now he does have a little bit more.
What?
Wow.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is over. Tyler.
Kevin in the corner.
Now the question here, will Dylan get the pops off with the 50?
Wow. That was too easy. That wasn't even a challenge.
I
and then first Tyler in the grand finals, and it was just a majestic best of three, and I came out with the belt.
It's very interesting because I feel like I always do really well. I win almost every game, I dominate everyone, and then I get to a title match and I just lose it. I don't know what it is. It might be something mental. I feel like I beat them in every situation except the title match. And twice now that's happened.
Name a date, name a game, I'm fucking bad.
GeekMania!
I think if I can beat Dylan in this match here, I can get over that hump and really come into my own and start taking titles off of people.
I'm the one at the very bottom and I lose, and I lose. And then after I'm done losing, I lose again. So, I mean, this match here, I think it'd be a great motivational piece for me.
I'm confident I can take this one, show everyone that I can win important matches.
I just want a good match, and you know, maybe that could lift my spirits.
Introducing first, the young fluff, Tyler! Introducing his opponent, the first ever GeekVerse Gauntlet champion and the number one contender, Dylan Moss!
Oh my god! Violence to start off between the friends.
Wow.
Here we are, ladies and gentlemen, at GeekMania, kings off some big action. This is the series finale of the GeekVerse Gauntlet. We're coming all the way home, really, because Tyler and Dylan faced off in our very first finale to crown the champion. These men both need a lot of momentum. Dylan, your top screen?
Yeah.
Dylan must his top screen, Tyler brings his bottom screen. They're playing a best of three. To win a match, you have to get 5 goals. Taylor Field, who is going to lose later on to Reuben later on tonight. Taylor Field, who do you think is going to be taking this? Because Tyler said he wants this win to establish himself, get him back in the championship rankings. Dylan Musk is going up against either you or Reuben in season 2, and he really needs a win because he's been kind of iffy. Wow, okay, so Tyler Briggs takes the first one?
Cool.
Tyler Briggs takes the first goal. Who are you going with here?
You know, I'm trying to think back at that matchup against you and Dylan.
I don't think that's much fair because I had never played Rocket League, so
no,
we don't know how good or bad Dylan Musk would be as far as skills.
That's true, but you know, I think didn't he get into the double digits there? Like, he really was able to dominate the field here. I mean, he just tied it up now.
He
so
did.
You know, like, they're both, I feel like they're both very even players. They're both going in headstrong and confident. Rocket League definitely takes some bit of skill. I mean, it's very hard to balance that all around the field and maintain the control of your vehicle. Like, based on your experience playing this game now, like, how do you feel?
Once again, I've only played it once. It is a hectic game. I'd love to play it again and see. I'd love to play against someone that hasn't played it because it's fun, but it's hard to control on a first time. They have said they have both experience with this. They've played each other. I think even if you're experienced with this, you can easily lose control of a vehicle. So right now, you have Dylan trying to play some defense right now. It seems like she's trying to get the ball away from his goal. 1-1 right now, so it's still close. They're both tied up.
And it's to 5, right?
It's to 5. The best of 3, yeah. Very important match, like I said, for both of them. It's all about momentum here in the Heat of Scotland. As you know, Taylor, momentum can make or break you.
Oh, yeah.
Oh man. Dylan Musk has taken the lead for the first time in this matchup. So here we go. Now, is Dylan Musk going to capitalize on this, or is this just going to motivate Tyler more to make a comeback and beat him? Oh, man. That was close.
That was very
Dylan kind of wiped out there, but that was close. So he was definitely working on something. and I think that's a win. Now, do you think that... Oh, is that a third? Oh, what a save by Tyler Briggs. They call him Young Fluff for a reason. And it's because he tells us to.
Dylan's doing a good job of keeping in Tyler's zone right now.
Yeah, he's played... Any time it has gone over to Dylan's net after he got scored on, he's done great defense.
What a save.
But Briggs is stepping up his goaltending. Like, he is... He's the man right now. Now Dylan Muss is on the ropes. He's falling over. Tyler Briggs. Oh, my goodness. What a miss. Tyler Briggs was so close to tying it up. Ooh, this is back and forth. Do you think this is indicative of Dylan Muss winning a crown? He's the first GeekVerse Gauntlet champion of all time. I feel like that's a little, you know, some taunting going on there. You know, mind games.
Yeah.
And you think about that. Who did he beat to become the first ever GeekVerse Gauntlet champion? Tyler Briggs. You know, there's a lot of history there. These two are friends, but you can tell there's something more motivating them. They both talked about how badly they needed this win. So now we have Dylan Muss circling around, but he wasn't happy with that move. As you can see on our screen, Dylan just shook his head. Oh, Dylan Muss takes a shot. Oh,
look at that.
Tyler Briggs put up a great fight as far as goaltending, but eventually something was going to give. So, hat trick. So, yeah, Dylan Muss has gone three in a row unanswered from Tyler Briggs. Wow, that was like Superman meeting Batman there right in the middle.
You know, it really comes down to how you're using your boosts, too. You got to really time it out well. And Dylan's doing just that.
Oh, Dylan almost got a beauty of a goal. Now Tyler Briggs is trying to take advantage. Tyler Briggs has finally answered the hat trick. 3-2. This is a close one. This is close. What a great way to start off GeekMania. Again. Oh, the immovable force, meaning the unstoppable object. Wow, just like that. I feel like when we talked about even with the league, you look at momentum in this match, it is swing. The second Dylan had it, three in a row. Second Tyler's had it, two in a row. Once you got momentum, that was really fortunate for Dylan Muss. That was just a little bit over to the right. Oh, it's a race. Dylan with a good save there, but he's not out of the forest yet. My goodness. Oh, good. Tyler could almost see what he was setting up there. Look at this. This is intense. You can feel the struggle. My goodness. Dylan Muss got a save there because he kind of set that up for Tyler accidentally. And that's the thing about Rocket League, just from what I've watched him play, you could easily accidentally set up your demise. So this is, because the next goal that can get this takes the first game. So this next goal is really crucial to the game. Dylan Muss is setting up. He's trying to back up. Man! He backed up a goal into the net. Wow, 4-3. Dylan needs one more goal and he takes the first game. Holy mackerel.
How do you feel about Tyler's chances right now?
I wouldn't count Tyler out. I thought after that hat trick it was not looking good, but he scored two goals very quickly. Look at this right now.
Back.
And he comes right back. You cannot count Tyler Briggs out. He wants this win. He wants to prove that he can win the big one. And then winning a match at GeekMania, that's a very big win. Here we go. Next goal. Wow. Go right to the roof. Next goal takes the first game in the best of three. Dylan tries to back up again. Can Tyler save it? No. Dylan Muss, just like that, takes the first game. 5-4, though. Man, what a close match. Just kicking this off. They felt each other out now. Oof. This is going to be an interesting match, too. Tyler needs to win this to force a tie and go to the best of three. Or is Dylan just going to pull a knockout and just take him out with 2-0? Oof. That could have gone anyway.
It could have gone. But, you know, I feel like Dylan, he took the lead in that first game, and Tyler responded and learned and adapted. Mm-hmm. I feel like this next round is going to be all about that. Tyler's going to step up his game and just make his comeback.
Tyler Briggs has done really good at the goaltending, but Dylan's been pulling out some moves, those backups. Very hard to plan for, you know? I'm almost wondering if he's just going to start backing up at the beginning. Dylan Muskett with a huge start. Just domination in that opening. Wow, 1-0 with 5 seconds into the second game. Tyler cannot... Oh, my goodness! Oh, just like that! Even quicker, in 2 seconds, Tyler Briggs scored on Dilmas, tying it up. These guys are going tit for tat. Oh, man. This time it goes to the side. They cannot both afford those goals to happen because they happen so quickly. You know that's very defeating right off the opening bell or whatever the fuck it is. They're just getting cool right away. Like, you don't want that. You want to have some momentum, and that just takes a breath out of you right now. They're fighting in the corner, doing lots of flips. The ball's been over there for a good little while. They're both trying to get it out there, but the problem is, they're trying to get it out, but you don't want to just throw it out there and pass it to the other opponent, exactly. Right? So you really got to be careful. Ooh, Dylan Musk missed the turn. Tyler Briggs looks like he's setting this up for a beauty shot. Oh, Dylan Musk was that a save? Oh, what's Tyler Briggs trying to take advantage. Dylan Musk is not letting this go easy. Oh, again, Dylan Musk misses. Just a little off.
There it is.
Tyler Briggs takes the lead in game 2.
He really took a step back and played a little bit of defense and offense at the same time.
Well, he wasn't rushing. And that's the thing, sometimes the rush helps, but he was really waiting to see the situation, see where it was going. Oof.
So this is the first time Tyler's taken the lead tonight.
Well, no, he took the lead in the very first game. Remember after that, he scored that one?
And
then done with Patrick, so. Now they're really feeling each other out. Now it's really who's gonna blink first. So we're closer to Dylan Musk's net right now, but Dylan Musk has been great on the goaltending tonight. Just trying to make some ground, trying to get it over there. Ooh, again, lots of just brick wall moves.
Yeah.
Lots of just the ball stopping in one spot. Ooh, this could go anyway. It's right in the middle. Who's gonna get there first? Ooh, Dylan Musk is getting there first, but he hasn't been able to set anything up and get it out of his zone. Tyler Briggs is up by 2-3-1. Dylan Musk has to answer this, or Tyler Briggs is going to take this and tie it all up.
Tyler showed much more dominance over the field this time around.
Mm-hmm. It definitely feels like he feels Dylan out, and he's trying to base his moves on what Dylan might do as far as his flips or his gameplay.
Oh.
But Dylan Musk is coming in. Like we said, he needed to come back, and that is what's happening right now. 3-2. Dylan's only down by 1, though. And we've seen the tide turn really easily tonight so far. So this could happen again. This is a big one. It's right in the middle, but it stops down the track.
Oh my
but Tyler
God.
Takes it! Oh, Dylan Musk, what a save! My goodness, I've seen a lot of close calls in the Gauntlet this year. That was maybe the closest. Dylan needs that goal. Oh, good. Yeah, good goaltending by Tyler Briggs. This is very much like the beginning of the match where they both feel like they're trying to make a move, but they don't. They're trying to, like I said, wait to see who's going to go first. Look, they both drove away from the ball. They're trying to say, Dylan must have tried to set some up that didn't exactly work out for him. Ooh, Tyler Briggs trying to take advantage. Can Dylan stop? Dylan needs to get this out of there. Tyler's going to take huge advantage and be up by 2 again.
Oh man!
It's not good for Tyler. It's Dylan Musk's goal to miss.
Oh my gosh.
Oh, Tyler, what a save. He's been on those saves like white on rice.
You know, that's the thing. Even if you got the ball dead in front of the net, that ball can move any other which way.
Mm-hmm.
Really playing the save. Got it here.
Yeah, it's been a big back and forth. There's been a big stalemate right now for a while. Last game was definitely a lot quicker as far as getting goals right away. This has been I feel like they're trying to plan their moves out a bit more, you know?
Yeah.
And you gotta think, probably times when these guys have played, it's been with multiple other people. 1v1 in any game is a lot different. Oof, Dylan
especially
really needs to, Rocket League, Dylan really needs to get it out of his core. The problem is, you trying to get out of your court might not set you up for a goal, though, which Dylan needs. So, oof. Anytime Dylan has gotten close and setting something up, Tyler's right there to kind of mess plans up.
Yeah, he's not rushing anymore. He's really learned from his mistakes.
Yeah.
And that's worked for him.
Ooh, Dylan undershot the jump. Oh, no, he's still going to score himself? Oh, that bounce could have went a bad
way. He's really having trouble getting out of his zone
it
right
is,
now.
Yeah, this, he literally just passed it to Tyler. Tyler, oh! A lot of hard work, but it paid off for Mr. Must. He tied it 3-3, two more goals, and he has won the whole series.
Do you think that was the plan? Do you think he was trying to lure Tyler in? And
I honestly
Tyler
don't.
Loiter around?
I honestly don't. I think Dylan was looking for the best opportunity, the best chance to score, but... Or, like, he was trying to. Tyler kept defending, and the first chance he got, he took it. I maybe there was some plan there. We talked to him after the match, but I don't know. It felt like he was just on the defense a lot. But they say the best offense is a good defense, right?
Exactly.
So.
Well, it's anyone's game right now. Mm-hmm. But still, ladies and gentlemen, Tyler needs to win this if he wants to carry on to the next round.
What a ruckus start to GeekMania. This is exactly what the Gauntlet's all about. Ooh, Tyler breaks is taking advantage, though. One little slip by Dylan might have set up a goal for Tyler, but see, he's done this a lot where he knows that we can't get a goal, he's not trying to force it, he'll go play defense.
Oh, that was
a big miscalculation, though. Dylan Moss has taken the lead again. Oh my goodness, one more goal and he's knocked Tyler out and he's gone a clean 2-0.
This got real very fast.
This did. Tyler is in a do or die situation. He needs two goals. He needs to start scoring. Because he's been playing a lot of defense and maybe hasn't exactly helped him. Oh. Not the right shot for him to try and take it, I think. I think he was smart to go back.
He's learned from that mistake.
He needs to get it out of here. Oh, Tyler just missed it going down the slope. Dilmas is coming up.
Oh.
He needs to get that ball out of there now. Dilmas is just like a fucking hyena circling him. Oh, Tyler Briggs keep missing it. I'm not sure if it's on purpose. Oh.
He's just deaconing around, Dylan.
It's just it's four.
Brilliantly
four.
Played.
Can Tyler tie up and force to a game three? We're going to find out right now. This has been back and forth. Here we go. This is a do or die situation for Tyler Briggs. Gotta send
it. Out of there.
Yeah. Tyler needs to send it back.
You know, he did really good, though, deking it around Dylan there, though. And
again, can he take advantage? Oof, I don't know. Dylan fucking rim. Dylan is looking clean and clear right now. Can Tyler get over there? Oh, Dylan is trying something to set him up. Oh, good. Good defense by Tyler. Oof. Anybody's game right now.
Dylan's really good for the ramp.
Yeah,
there.
Dylan, is that strategy or is that just an insult? Oh, Tyler needs to get it away from Dylan or this is the end for him. Oof. Oh, Tyler looked like he's taking the goaltending route instead of he could have rushed for it. Is that, I don't know if that was the right move, Taylor.
I think it's the right move. You know,
yeah,
you gotta,
but is it?
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
You don't, he didn't know. But is it though? He's not out of the woods yet. Oh,
my god!
He needs to right now. Even like they do in soccer sometimes, just to boot down there, take a break. I think he needs a mental break, but he's not. He's going for the goal. Because the thing is, Dylan can afford to lose this game. It's not over for him yet.
Mm-hmm.
So Dylan could be reserving some energy, but it doesn't even look like. Dylan looks like he wants to finish this off right now. Oh, what a move.
Wow.
Can Tyler take advantage of this?
Oh my god!
Oh! It is tied! A game apiece! We are going to game three here at GeekMania! My god, both these men, you can taste it in the air. It is palpable, you can cut the tension with a knife! These men want this win! Woo! Here we go, game three!
Yeah, you can feel it. You can tell it. And you know, there's a good sportsmanship there throughout this whole thing. They both have earned their spot here in this third round.
Here we go. For all the marbles, next percent wins this, wins the match. Can Dylan, the number one contender, gain some great momentum going to season two when he gets his title shot? Or can Tyler Briggs start a redemption tour? And he wants to get in that title picture. This would really help in the future to make a case to someone like myself, who's a new commissioner. why he should be a contender.
He missed his defensive.
Yeah. Whoa, that's a rarity for Tana as we've seen so far. He's missed a couple, but he usually is good on the goaltending. It's usually Dylan gets a score when Tana's off the side.
Yeah.
That time Dylan right flat out deep the mountain got him.
Yeah.
And Dylan is taking a big lead. Now that's a big lead. By one, like any lead right now is a big lead. Tyler's trying to set up a little too high. He's trying to get that rebound. Ooh, he needs to get on that a bit more.
Wow, well played.
Oh, Tyler set this up perfectly. I don't know how Dylan can stop that.
Yeah,
that was a pitch perfect picture goal. Tied 1-1. First of five wins. Winner of this has won the entire match. Dylan took a...
Good clear.
That was Dylan's really good. There. Yeah, Dylan really recovered. I was worried the way he sped back like that and Tyler hit him, but... Tyler missed
it.
Oh, but Dylan could not take advantage.
Tyler just wiped Dylan out off the field.
I don't think it was... Do you think that was the right timing, though? It didn't look like he got to use the advantage up, but I could be wrong, because it looks like a goal is happening right there. So he did use it in the right time. That demolition, perfect placement by Tyler Briggs.
But, I mean, this whole night has been close, so...
Oh, yeah.
Is Tyler going to get that?
Oh, bad bounce for Dylan! Awful bounce for Dylan. You hate to see that.
Yeah.
You hate to see that. Three, he got a hat trick. That's three unanswered goals by Dylan. He really needs to step it up or something bad. Because I think if Tyler Briggs gets a 4-1 lead, I don't think he can overcome that. Just because this game has a lot of chance. Dylan Muss is one of the best we have, arguably the best player in the league, but a 4-1 deficit, that is a lot. Dylan, is that strategy or is he a little mad right now? Because he's doing a lot of ramming.
I think he's a little mad.
Perfect goal.
I thought he had that.
Me too. I thought Tyler saved it, but Dylan, that was perfect placement by Dylan. Right time, right place.
So he must feel a bit better. You know, he's just down by one now. That's okay.
But he doesn't want to let off the gas, literally and figuratively. He wants to keep that momentum going because he's still down by one. It's only one, but it's still down by one. Tyler Briggs missed that ball.
There's no room for missing it. You need to be on it this time.
You cannot afford to miss. A lot of the goals we've seen tonight have happened because just the slightest miss.
Set up a little bit here.
There's a lot of back and forth. The ball's been in the middle for quite a while here these past few seconds, so they're definitely a game of chicken almost.
Yeah.
Tyler Briggs chose to do the goaltending. Is this going to help him hurt? It worked out for him. He's trying to make something happen. Dilmas rushes to his goal. Very good by Dylan Muss. Tyler Briggs trying to get back to his goal. That's the risk you take when you go for a goal like that. If you're trying to bring
him
back. Ties it up. Just like every match so far, these two have been neck and neck. And now a hat trick by Dylan Muss. Three unanswered goals by Tyler. So let me get your prediction right now. Who's taking it?
You know, I feel like Dylan really wants it right now.
Mm-hmm.
He is working hard. He has come back.
Damn. One more goal and Dylan Muss is going to take the win.
I'm not counting Tyler out. You know, I'm thinking Tyler, I think he's going to make his comeback here. I think he's working hard for it.
But who are you picking?
You know, I think I'm gonna pick Tyler.
I'll pick Dylan.
And he's working for it.
Dylan has the lead right now, but man,
here we go,
ladies and gentlemen, here at GeekMania, 4-4, a game apiece. The winner gets a W and a whole bunch of momentum going into next year's GeekVerse Gauntlet. This is their last match they're playing of the season. You know this means a lot to them both. Here we go. A stalemate, it's more on the side of Tyler Briggs' net, but he has possession of it. He's taking it to the sides. Dylan Muss is coming like a bat out of hell over there.
They're playing safe.
That's
the name of this game right now.
Yeah. Dylan Muss with a good hit. It is in the side. He has some control. Can Tyler get over there?
He does.
Great flip. Good clear by Tyler Briggs. Nice placement, but Dylan Muss is right there to stop him. These two are neck and neck. Wow. Oh my god. Oh. Just a few inches over would have been just a bit better for him.
You know, it's all down to the boost. Whoever's got that boost for those certain opportunities right now.
Oh, it is so close! Oh my goodness! It is so close to Tyler Smith! He needs to get it out of there! Wow! Holy Christ! Wow! Both Tyler missed it, but Dilmas missed the hit, went right into his net. Tyler has to be thanking the heavens right now because he saw his life flash before his eyes. Yeah. Man, that was close. I cannot believe that.
It almost looked like Dilmas keeping it out of Tyler's net.
Yeah. Tyler says, that's a nice straight shot. Oh.
He misses, but he's going in again.
Oh, he misses it. It's time to take advantage. It's looking like it's over. It's Tyler's game to lose right here. Tyler has taken the win. Oh, my God. What a match. You talk about the best matches in GeekVerse history. These men have nothing to not be proud of. That was phenomenal.
Oh my god.
Oh wow, Dill's not even staying for an interview.
Oh, he's not even in the room.
He's he literally just left that out.
Yeah, he's gone.
Wow. See, you talk about the sportsmanship. I think that meant so much to Dill and Les that he, I don't know. I don't even know if we're going to get to hear a word from him, but man, I'll sit down with Tyler and talk to him, but that was crazy.
Does that make sense?
Okay. Tyler, can you take a seat?
Not right there.
Fuck you guys, that was so good. Is this gonna stir sound in a second?
No.
Tyler Briggs, what a win that was. That was, like I said just previously, I think that was one of the close matches. Like I think about Dylan and Jessica and Mario Kart, Taylor and Kirklin and Cod. This is right up there, maybe the closest. How are you feeling? Not only because of that match, but you were talking about before, you needed a big win. You're coming off two title losses. People are questioning, can you win big? I think you just won big there. How are you feeling right now? A lot of emotions.
Still stressed out somehow. Definitely relieved. Oh my goodness, that was insane. I mean, that was one of the most back and forth games I feel like I've had. Usually when I've been playing, it's been like, I've been either dominating or I've been getting dominated, I find.
Each game you guys were neck and neck, and it came down to the last goal.
Oh my goodness. Mm-hmm. I think the key turning point was that when I tied it up to 4-4, because just the goal before, Dylan got like, it was a nice shot. Mm-hmm. And normally we've been skipping the replays after each goal. He made me watch that whole thing. I was a little bit salty.
You can tell. The tension's really rising.
Oh, man. Yeah. And then I got that one, 100% luck. It just got a nice, good bounce off the face off there and just went in. I made Dylan watch that. I think he's on tilt a little bit because there's a chance there on that one, the 4-4, when he had a good chance, like an open net, and he just barely missed it.
Mm.
And I think that was because he's a little salty.
Mm.
And then I managed to wait for him to make a mistake, easy straight in shot.
So do you think that salt, he wasn't disrespectful to you and anything when he walked up, but he clearly needed a second, he clearly needed to be alone. Do you think that was just a personal thing, or do you think he maybe is a little salty at you, a little mad, because he literally just left the house. We don't,
I think
like,
he's a little upset.
He has to commentate the rest of GeekMania. I have to go find him. He's the commentator for the rest of the show. So what are you, like, do you take any offense to that, or what are you feeling? Are you unsure at the moment?
I'm not taking too much offense to it. I think it feels good to get on his nerves a little bit, but I think when he gets back, he'll calm down a little bit, and we'll be back to being friends.
I hope, because if you can't, I could feel that this could happen again in a title match. Dylan has a title match coming up. There's a chance he may hold a grudge against you for a little while after this. You know, it might be his goal to get that title. I could see his next goal be coming after you.
It's definitely possible. I mean, I'm never a fan of people disrespecting the handshake. I think it's a sacred tradition for gaming all over the world, and to disrespect that is to disrespect gamers everywhere.
Well, you heard from Tyler Briggs. I will actually shake your hand right now because I am the commissioner. I own this. I have said this before. I think you are a future champion. If Taylor Field can win the goddamn title, Tyler Briggs is going to one day win the title. Thank you for watching this match. Please stay tuned. We got a bunch more matches coming up just in mere seconds.
Hello, geeks. Have you subscribed to GeekVerse Podcast on our video or audio feeds? No? Then what are you doing? Every Friday night, live on YouTube, the geeks get together for madness and to break down geek news, whether that's DC, Marvel, Star Wars, video games, film reviews, comic books, everything circling the Geekverse. We talk about it live. Join us, come in the live chat, hit us up, make fun of Taylor Field, it's all good. And then the audio feed drops Friday night or Saturday morning. Then check out all our other spin-off shows, Netflix and Fail. Do you like bad movies? Well, you're gonna like this podcast. Cantina Conversations, a show that's all about Star Wars. Geek's Creed, where Taylor and Reuben talk about everything concerning the Assassin's Creed franchise. Our comic book-centric podcast, Dynamic Duo. Our retrospective series, where we review a film and we review a franchise film by film. We've done MCU, Saw, Batman, and even the 1994 classic animated Spider-Man series. You have all these shows and many, many more. So head over and give us a like, give us a share, subscribe to join the madness. And if you really like us, head over to Patreon. And you see that spare change that's sitting in front of you right there? Throw it over to us. You know why? Because we really need to replace Taylor Field, and his legal fees cost quite a bit. So we need some cheddar. So thank you very much for enjoying all the past content and all the future content. Please head over to GeekVersePodcast.com, Twitter, or Facebook for any details you may want, or to contact us. And until then, we'll see you in the search bar.
The Sports GeekVerse Gauntlet Championship. This is going to be a championship that can only be won when sports games are contested. I've been talking with somebody, and I have a mystery opponent. Great mystery opponents. You know, we love those at the Gauntlet. A mystery opponent is going to verse the winner of this match that will be happening this weekend.
I feel like I'm going to have to cheese it, honestly. I'm going to have to use some OP tactics, use some power-ups. Some power-ups that are kind of a scumbag move, but, you know, whatever gets me the title, or what gets me to the title, so I gotta do what I can, you know? Right. All friendships aside, you just gotta give it your all.
Well, we did play some warm-up matches already, and I will say that Kirklin cheated, straight up, 100%, so I feel like, you know, I can either go one of two ways. I can cheat too, and hope that it works out in my favor, or, you know, I can play honest, and then I look like the better person when I win. I mean, I definitely feel like I'm gonna have to give some payback for Kirklin for doing so bad as my partner in the Newlywed game. So, I mean, there's still a little salt in the wound from that, let's be honest.
The winner is going to GeekMania and getting a shot to be the first ever Sports GeekVerse Gauntlet champion versus a mystery opponent. Who knows? Introducing first, the ghost, Jessica! Oh wow, what an entrance! Introducing her opponent, Kirklin, Patser!
Well, let's go.
Sunzo, Gunzo.
Well, folks, we are here. GeekMania. Oh, Jessica.
Who's that character in the back right?
Speed and attacks. I don't know. Speed increase 20 range. Attack with 40
range. A squid. Jessica versus Kirklin. Two good friends facing off.
Also sworn enemies.
Are they?
Yes. Yeah.
When did that happen?
Oh.
It's
last night.
You guys missed season two. I don't know.
So this is a game that Jessica put in the gauntlet initially. She's been waiting a long time. And both these guys did not have a match for GeekMania. So
it has been played before, though. Mm-hmm. Me and Tyler.
But it felt like a perfect matchup for GeekMania. They both need an opponent.
They actually know how to play this game.
Mm-hmm. So, and yeah, so Dylan, you want to speak from experience. To decide our very first championship, when you won the title, you did lose this match, though.
I did lose this game.
And how do you feel about this, and who are you putting your weight behind?
I had no idea what was going on the entire time. I don't know why Tyler won. I don't know why I lost. It was one of the stupidest games I've ever played in my life.
Wow.
Dylan
Salt
Mass. I didn't really know what I was doing. But these guys do know what they're doing, mm-hmm. So I think this will be a better match than me and Tyler's. Because even Tyler, I think he won and he didn't even like realize why. Yeah. It was kind of just a mess, but, mm-hmm. You know, it's a cool game, I guess. Downtown Race.
And now, how do you win this again?
I don't know. I think this is different than what me and Tyler were doing.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Well, actually, we did a race, but I think this is more of a typical kind of race.
Sonic with the sick
swagging out.
That's over there. I would ask Taylor, but I don't care what he thinks, so.
Oh, thank you. But you know what? This belt.
Wow, they just battered that car, and then it disappeared into thin air.
So, Dylan, I did not get your pick. Who are you picking?
Yeah. I'll go with Jessica.
Okay.
Sorry, Kirklin.
He wasn't here for the practice rounds that Kirklin won, though, so.
Right, but I know you were holding back. How about you guys? Yeah. Who are your picks?
I'll pick Kirklin.
Taylor?
I'm trying to figure out, so is Kirklin's Shadow? Oh, yeah. Jessica's Sonic?
Oh, yeah. Jessica's Sonic, Kirklin's Shadow, left Kirklin, right Jessica. So, just for the viewers to be clear on that.
You know, it's very even right now. It's hard as all.
That's huge.
I'm going to say Jessica.
That's huge.
You're going to say Jessica right now, Kirklin gets Sonic? Wow. So, they're getting very close to the finish line.
Yeah.
Well, do
that's
like
fine.
Best
Let's do best three.
Yeah.
Always ever, the rules are always ever.
Oh, nice turn by Jessica.
The rules are always changing in the Geekverse Gauntlet.
And then she did a backflip.
So Kirklin takes the first round. It's a mini map, but he takes the first race. So 1 point in the win column for Kirklin.
That was like, yeah, that was
the next match to sign
to,
right?
Yes.
Yeah, without the actual running part.
There's
walls. So now we gotta see if Jessica can tie it up and force a third match in the series. I think she can. That was very close. Kirklin won, but not convincingly won.
I would not recommend the bottom right one. Yeah, Radical Highway? Not so radical. It is certainly a highway, though. Oh, white jungle.
Opposed to the green jungle?
I think there was a green jungle.
Yeah, that's the next stage.
Really? Original titles back in the day.
It's a huge story point why the jungle turns from white to green.
I don't know why I have
it's a pretty swaggin' outfit.
So again, Kirklin is Shadow, Jessica is Sonic.
Oh, they're on foot now.
Mm-hmm. Oh, man. This is how I get in my cardio.
Well, Kirklin knows what he's doing. I don't know what he's doing, but it looks...
He's doing it.
Interesting.
Mm-hmm.
He's doing it. You're not wrong.
Lots of balancing.
This game is very hectic.
It is. I feel like people that do cocaine would love this game.
Right. People who do cocaine... irrelevant to us.
Yeah, I don't know. Have you ever had a conversation with Taylor? I wonder sometimes.
I feel like these guys sometimes.
On the guys on cocaine?
No, like Shadow and Sonic.
See, I told you.
These guys.
No wonder I have such a bad attitude. Piece of shit.
So Jessica's running really fast. No one really knows where she's running
but
to.
Still but behind Kirklin. Kirklin has gotten a good lead. Oh, Kirklin getting a concussion almost.
Concussion.
Oh, something's happening.
Oh, wow. Jessica got stunned. But she kind of made it work out.
But they're caught up. I never understand the length of this game. It seems like someone's... super far behind, and then all of a sudden...
Yeah, it's not linear in any way.
No.
It's very, very
much
vertical,
like Pulp Fiction.
Much like Pulp Fiction, yeah.
Some people call this Pulp Fiction the video game.
It's been called that by you just now.
Yeah.
Alright, so right now Kirklin does
close.
Have a very minor lead.
Very minor lead, yeah. Jessica seems she's very close. She hasn't taken the lead back, but she's very close to it.
She knows
times.
What she got, what she has to do. I don't know. I might have just made that up. She's having fun. She's laughing, having a good time. Yeah, that ability is pretty OP. I don't know why there needs to be a cutscene every time he does it, but, I mean.
Jessica needs to gain some ground here.
Yeah, she's quite a bit behind now. But that's the thing, like, I think it's how, like, physically far away they are. So when you're on, like, a long stretch of running, it might seem like you're really far ahead, even though it's about the same amount of time as a... Oh, wow. This could be it right here. Kirklin is on his insane pace right now. He is speed running the game right now. I don't think he really knows either. Oh, wow.
Kirklin is very close to the finish line.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Kirklin.
That was bullshit.
Now, listen.
I hate how the power button is the same as the roll.
Wow. Strange competition, as in Kirklin apologizes for
very silly
winning.
Name. Very silly game.
Mm-hmm.
You don't feel good about winning. You just kind of win.
So you just keep going, or?
No. Well, you kind of won, I guess.
Yeah,
you can do a best of five if you want, for the fans.
I mean,
well, it won't make air, but you can definitely...
That first one was kind of a mini game, so you want to do one more?
Sure.
Okay. Nice.
Green Forest?
That's a very good sport right there, I'd have to say.
Metal Harbor. This is a good one. So, we've changed the best of three to a best of five.
We're nullifying the first one.
Even though we're
on the hard one, we
Travis is a real stickler for the rules, so when shit like this happens, he just gets really, really mad.
I like to lay him out. You know, we're on a schedule. Give me a big event.
Oh, we have all night.
What?
Quit your whining.
No, we don't.
The pizzas aren't even here yet.
No, you don't get pizza. You're not on main Dunn's team.
Pizza.
All right, so they're pretty even once again.
Mm-hmm.
This one has some climbing elements like the Radical Highway does.
Oh,
I don't know what Jessica's doing, but it looks pretty cool.
Mm. Something I
this
do
is what Sonic does in
Smash Saturdays.
No, it's
yeah.
Saturday right now. I didn't see you do any of this.
Nighttime.
Oh, okay. So we're just getting started is what you're saying?
Oh, yeah.
Okay. Oh wow, she just dodged those airplanes.
She did. Kirklin has lead, but she's catching up.
Nice move by Kirklin. It almost looks like when Shadow kind of wags back and forth like that, it looks like Kirklin's doing it, but I feel like that's just how he moves.
Now Jessica's very close to catching Kirklin, taking a lead, but Kirklin is not letting up.
Yeah, that's true. The camera in this game is even more hectic than Melee. It's just all over the place, man.
Oh. Kirklin has fallen off the
thing. That's huge.
Can
He went back like a third. Wow. A third of the map.
Wow. Jessica needs to take advantage of this to stay in it.
Will Kirklin regret giving away that first win?
10 seconds, but falls again. How far is he going back this time?
Look at this interactive gameplay. Jessica just gets to do nothing for 10 seconds.
Yeah.
Pretty fun.
Kirklin has fallen for a hat trick. Three times it's fallen.
That's not what you want.
If Jessica cannot take advantage of this. Wow. But Kirklin...
Does Sonic not have these abilities? I remember
and
this
how many times can
Tyler
Shadow
too.
Use this ability? Just as much
endlessly.
As... Really?
Oh, yeah.
What a broken game.
I would agree with that wholeheartedly.
But, you know, this is what the folks picked. You know, they wanted this. They got it.
This is probably one of those games where you played it as a kid and you love it. You come back and play it 2017. You're like, this game fucking
Sonic
sucks.
Man.
Nope. There, Sonic did some pump-up.
It looks like Jessica's almost there.
Water seems to
and
be
I
Kirklin.
This
I made
is
sure not to grab that.
Kirklin's choking right now.
Stops her right before the finish line. Maybe Kirklin can make a huge comeback here. It's not looking likely, as water seems to be his disadvantage in this game. I think that throws him off.
No, hedgehogs aren't good in the water.
No. Notorious from that great documentary.
So will Kirklin regret giving away that game one?
He could, you know, that's why I usually stick to the rules, because he could have got a quick win there, but you know, I hope he loses in the end, you
rules
know?
Are for the weak of mind. Huh? I like to see people who on the fly can adjust and adapt.
Well, I don't think Kirkland's one of those people.
I almost want to see a Radical Highway.
Oh no. Dylan's getting nostalgia behind
it. I think you guys can go down, I think there's more levels.
Yeah.
Can you not scroll down?
There's one more.
Yeah, we did it earlier. It was awful.
Oh,
okay.
Awful.
It's worse than Radical Highway.
Yeah, see, Dylan?
So, awful. Okay, this is a classic map. Now, I know all about this map.
You studied
super
it.
Super classic.
I live and die by this map. Actually, I don't, yeah. Well, I remember the thing when me and Tyler played this map is we didn't win by getting to the end. We ran out of time.
Oh, yeah,
because,
we did that, too.
So, I don't know if
there's no time, though.
Is it just not show it, or is it...
Oh,
okay. So these guys like to take their sweet time.
Okay, so Jessica can either tie up the series, or Kirklin's
going
to win
it here.
Right now
they are on the exact same pace, nearly. This is as close as it gets.
So Kirklin can win it here, Jessica can tie it all up.
Oh, she just destroyed that bot for no particular reason.
He looked a little shady. So I think
he
there was
did
a
look
reason.
A little shady,
yeah.
Right.
So
Kirklin's got his rollerblades on, he is running.
And that's not even the video.
Or rolling, even.
Yeah. Now, I feel like the first few matches, Kirklin had the distinct advantage, took a big lead each time. But last match, which Jessica won, they were pretty even. Jessica took
right,
the lead. And
right, fell off the map.
Yeah. And right now, Jessica seems to be...
Chaos Spear. Look at that.
They've been very close this whole matchup, though, so far.
I can't tell who's in the lead.
I think Kirklin is by...
He is by a tiny little
I guess,
map.
But... Yeah, no, now Sonic's taking the lead. So it's back and forth.
Oh, that was glitchy, but we'll take those.
And yeah, Kirklin may regret this, you know, because these two...
I don't think he will.
If he loses, he's last in the gauntlet now. He's had a few losses.
You know, that's
belt.
Not what you want, but when you get that comeback, it's even better, right?
Can you get the comeback, though?
People
he's
have done it before.
It.
People have done it before.
Yeah, Taylor may have done it, like, cheating, so...
Oh, Jessica's got to wait for that elevator.
Jessica tried to take a risk.
I think she meant
I don't think so. She tried to take a risk. I don't think it paid off.
Kirklin is gaining quite a bit of ground, but like I said earlier, it might just look like it on the line because he's been cruising around.
Yeah.
Whereas when Jessica gets on that line, she's gonna catch up pretty quick. So.
Plus, you never know when some water may just appear and rattle Kirklin.
Water is his weakness.
Mm-hmm. Both
look at
shadows
that.
And Kirklin, the man himself, cannot swim.
Don't know what Kirklin's doing, but it's pretty funky and fresh.
Is it?
You have to hit certain buttons together.
Do you?
I don't know.
I don't think
Taylor
buttons.
Giving the fans false information.
Oh, it looks like Jessica's going above? Or is this what Kirklin did as well?
Oh, free falling. Oh, where did Kirklin go
oh,
to
she
default?
Used the
she is here. Gaining up. Kirklin has gone hit and knocked
this
down
is,
a few times.
This could be the comeback right here. Mm-hmm.
And Jessica is good in these clutch situations.
Oh, nice.
Falls off the bridge.
Nice play by Kirklin.
But she's still not too far.
Well, the funny thing is she got knocked off the map, but I think she got closer to Kirklin. Like, it respawned her closer to him.
It's a great game.
Got a checkpoint.
That's what you want.
Mm. Okay, so she needs to make a comeback now. We are
look at this highway. She's
maybe a quarter away from the finish line, less than, so.
You never know with this game.
It could be halfway.
An hour and a half still.
Yeah. Jessica needs to pick up the pace to tie the series, or Kirklin is going to get the W here.
She's catching up. Oh, look at that. See, they're like 2 seconds behind each other right now.
Wow. Oh, but well, that's...
nice play, I think.
Oh, using... Oh. Oh, wow.
I really don't understand why Jessica doesn't get that 10-second stun. It doesn't seem that fair. Oh. Kirklin trash-talking right now.
Oh, Kirklin is taking a lot of damage in this match. Oh my god! Jessica took a huge boost.
No.
Oh, but into a wall! Oh my god, it is back and forth! Oh, it is coming down to the wire! Oh my goodness, but I think Kirklin has it right now.
Oh no.
Crosses the finish line, hits the ring. Kirklin Patzer takes the win.
Congratulations.
Good game, ladies and gentlemen.
Wow.
Good game. Hello, geeks. We have a huge announcement and a big favor to ask. November 4th is our Extra Life charity stream. We are going 24 hours straight of gaming and madness. Yes, just us locked in a room. I think we'll survive, but you never know. All the money we can raise from now until November 4th will go towards the BC Children's Hospital Foundation. So please, $1, $5, $10, $50, any amount will help, and all of it will go to a great cause. And plus, if we can hit our goal of $500, Dylan Muss is going to shave his head bald live on air. That's right, if we hit the 500, he's losing all that hair. So please join us for a lot of fun on November 4th. We're going to be streaming Super Mario Kart, Mario Party, Goldeneye. We're going to have a 6-round tournament to determine a new number one contender for the GeekVerse Gauntlet title with a very special twist. What is that? Tune in to find out. And please, if you cannot donate, like the post, share the stream. Please tune in November 4th because we want to spread as much awareness as possible as this is going towards a great cause and anything you can do will help. So we hope to see you November 4th and until then, see you in the search bar.
Hello ladies and gentlemen, we're back here at GeekMania, back in Dylan's basement. We've had a nice fresh change of clothes. Kirklin Patzer is here. He beat Jessica earlier. You're one match away from winning and you're going to get the prestigious new sports title. How do you feel about your upcoming match, and you don't know who your opponent is coming up, so how do you feel? How are you preparing right now?
I feel like not knowing who my opponent be doesn't really affect me at all. It doesn't matter who I'm going to be playing against. I feel like I'll basically have similar strategies no matter who I'm playing against and going into it. I feel confident. This is probably one of my favorite genres of games, so I feel very confident. I have a lot of experience, a lot of practice, a lot of hours playing these titles. Not necessarily these titles, but similar titles, so I feel like going into it, I have a good base set of skills.
And this is your first best of three. You've never been in a title match before, so you play three separate games. Are you going to be able to adapt to that method?
The longevity of the series might... I mean, no. I'll take that back. It won't affect me at all. I'm ready.
Wow.
I'm ready to go. No matter how many games it takes, I feel like it'll be over in two.
Okay. Well, we're going to find out Kirklin's opponent right now. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing Kirklin's opponent... competing against him to become the first ever GeekVerse Gauntlet sports video game champion, the dashing, one of the best video game players in the world, the handsome, the Canadian psycho, the longest reigning GeekVerse Gauntlet champion of all time, and the chairman of GeekVerse Gauntlet, Travis Snell.
Alright, here we go.
Alright, here we go, Taylor.
Friday Night Lights.
Here we go. So, we got a crisp, clean match of football here between Kirklin and Travis. It's going to be a 5-minute timer. I'm gonna guess Travis is the Green Bay Packers, and I don't know who Kirklin is.
He's the other team.
The Patriots.
The New England Patriots, yes.
New England Patriots.
I think Taylor should be escorted. I'm trying to win a championship. I can't focus with that.
Travis is already out of the game. He's talking to Taylor.
He's not. He can't be paying attention to us. He's got to pay attention to the game.
I know.
But, like, a terrible play for a terrible
So we were saying just earlier.
I'm just kidding.
You don't know much about... Like, these games.
I know nothing about these games. That's why I'm a bit salty watching this.
Top three choices.
You've never played any. Maybe, like, a few minutes in your life?
I played a few minutes, but, like, what we just saw there, I lost my interest in the game because you there's not enough play time.
And then you got...
Yeah, I think it's more about the strategy of it than actually having fun playing the game. Yeah.
You know, I'm not one for turn-based strategy games. This feels like a turn-based strategy game.
All right, Mr. Jurassic Park?
It pretty much is. It pretty much is.
Mr. Jurassic Park.
Do you like football, like watching it on TV or anything?
You know, if it's like, if it's...
Oh, yeah, they're getting me trophies.
Fuck!
Woo!
First down.
Good job, Kirklin.
Shut up!
Oh, look at this guy.
Don't be biased.
You know, this is the guy that had to forfeit this belt here.
Yikes.
You needed four other people to beat me. Shut the fuck up.
I just needed me. That's all it took. Video
evidence. You're on the chairman now.
Chairman doesn't mean anything. This is what this means.
Someday the commentators are going to have the gracious pleasure to record in a room separate from Travis. Because he always just distracts and tries to, you know, run the whole thing.
I'm the chairman. I should run the whole thing.
He's the chairman.
He's getting pulled out of the game here.
Just to throw some more shade Travis's way, I'll give you this, Taylor. Before today, Kirklin had no idea who he was playing against. Whereas Travis has time to prepare for months... Even years, you could say, for this match. That's pretty fraudulent.
It is fraudulent. You know, he sent me the links to his live streams of him training on this game, actually.
I find it odd he would send me his links.
That's why I would never send Taylor a live stream link.
I'd like to see that live stream link.
I will.
Make sure you post it in the chat.
I will post it in the chat. I'll pull it up for you. Totes.
All right, so it looks like Kirklin is about to score a touchdown, potentially. We'll see if Travis...
Oh, flag.
Oh.
What's the flag?
You didn't hut in time.
You didn't hut in time.
Woo!
Oh, come on.
Yeah,
man.
Give me that 5 yards, baby!
Oh, come on.
Oh, yeah, I'm excited.
Now, these rules seem as fraudulent as wrestling, if you ask me.
Well, I'd say there's a little bit more structure than wrestling.
Just trying to...
I think the timer in this game actually goes down in...
It does. The timer works actually properly.
In real-life increments rather than made-up seconds.
Real-life increments.
So, yeah, this is a five-minute game. We're already at 2 minutes 40 seconds. I suggested a longer timer, but these guys think they know...
Dill must have been right on that front.
Yeah, so this is... There's probably time for 1 point. And we're moving on, but, you know...
What do you think first and 15 means?
Well, because you get, like, 4 downs or something like that. Oh. And I don't know, dude. I don't know the rules of this game.
It just collapses and explaining on it.
I can tell you about the pinch bug zero, though. The pinch bug zero is one of my favorite strategies because it really just... You really just pinch in there and you buck them out like a raving deer.
No,
raving
what happens deer. Is the quarters are 5 minutes, so it's 4 quarters. So it'll... And it's not a full 5 minutes. So, there you go.
I don't know what he just said, but that doesn't matter.
You'll see. It's not a full... You get 5 minutes for every quarter, but the game accelerates when you pick a play. So, because in real time... See how it just went down quickly? So, realistically, it will be about a 10-minute match. The first match.
Alright.
Is this it?
Alright, Brady, what do you got?
No!
Yeah, that's kind of weird. See how it, like, pauses for, like, 3 seconds to turn the camera
around? It really throws you off.
Very bizarre.
No way!
That guy's a fast runner.
Oh.
That one, Kirklin's man there just fell.
Oh.
Who are you rooting for?
Travis
right now?
Snow, baby!
Well, you know, honestly, I'm rooting for Travis, and here's why. Because I hear that Kirklin has a lot more experience in our next game that we're playing. And so I just like to see a nice close set with all three matches. So I'm going to root for Travis here because I think Kirkland can get the next one and then we can see that game three.
Absolutely.
I'll remember that as the new chairman.
But I'd also like to see Travis lose, so.
I will remember that as the new chairman.
I think everyone wants to see him lose.
Yeah, it'd be funny to see him get clean 0-2'd, you know? That would be nice. That would be spicy.
I don't think I've seen that yet in the Gauntlet.
I think you've seen it before.
Well, with myself, but you know, not with Travis.
Yeah.
Don't lie. You've never O2'd somebody. He's just making up facts.
I meant I got O2'd.
Oh, well, yeah, because you suck.
Yeah, but you know what? I suck. But look what I got.
Yeah, you're gonna lose it later. No. You're gonna lose it later to Reuben.
No.
Reuben.
Oh, look at that.
I don't know why you dropped it. Butterfingers.
Butterfingers.
It's raining. It's nighttime.
These are NFL professionals. The rain doesn't mean diddly squat.
He just did diddly squat.
It kind of feels like Helm's Deep, but really lame and not interesting at all.
Last down.
We got the Prowl Bear Blitz. This is one of my least favorite. It's just too obvious what the plan is. I like to see some creativity, but this one's just so basic.
Very prowling.
Yeah, very prowling.
Oh.
Wow.
Now you
he didn't even try. You know how professional soccer players are like fake injuries a lot?
Yeah.
I feel like that's what that guy just did.
That's exactly what he did.
Scary.
So you can punt to
make that injury.
Well, because if
so,
I,
this
if
is the Max Cover
here,
punt. It's named after a guy named Max Cover, he was a great football player in the early 80s, and he had a famous punt, and then they named the move right after him.
What is a punt?
A punt? That's when you just you just kick the shit out of it.
So if you punt it, you can play defense. Yeah, because then because if I got it, that's where I'd get it. And so now you can punt. So.
And so you want to kick that just.
Over here.
Just over there.
Over there.
Like really far away, you know?
Okay.
Okay. Nice little drop kick.
First time the Canadian cycles on offense.
Oh, kicked it right to him. He didn't even have to move there. Oh, nice try.
Whoa!
I excel in defense.
Oh, that guy had big ears. You see that guy in the background?
He had huge ears.
Don't talk about Mike McCarthy like that.
Mike McCarthy?
McCarthy. He's the
Mike McCarthy.
Jesse McCarthy.
Oh, this plan looks pretty sweet.
This is a solid plan.
So now there's another 5-minute timer. I don't know how the timer in this game is.
There's four quarters and you get 5 minutes in each. There you go.
What happens after the four quarters up?
That's when the game ends. And that's when I win this round.
How many quarters have you gone through?
One. It says right there. We're on the second one. There's four.
It doesn't say which quarter. It just says second.
Yeah. That could have been
one
like
has
the second
to assume.
Play of the second down of the second. Who knows?
See, if I even pull off any victory, it's a miracle because I got the fucking peanut gallery back there.
Peanut gallery.
The only one throwing peanuts around here is you, Travis.
Wow.
What are you saying?
I think he's talking about your manhood.
Defense, pick a play.
All right, so right now Travis is up by a clean 7 points on the scoreboard. I believe a touchdown is worth 6. Could be wrong.
Really?
I don't know where he got the other measly point from.
I think it's...
Oh my god!
Let's go! Wow.
Fuck!
That's what happens when you're a Travis.
That's how we played defense.
That was very nice.
Woo!
So now he can land that 7th point by kicking it through, like, in between the crossbars.
That gives you 1 point?
I think it gives you 1 point, because Travis landed it earlier and got that 7th point.
It must be then. Oh,
so
this looks easy. Even I can hit this one.
I hope so.
Boom.
There you go.
I guess that's 7th point.
Go.
Another tie.
We get that back. Let's go. Hype him up.
Fuck! 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 Fuck!
So you want Travis to win, but who is your money actually
on right
now? I don't
really want him to win.
You
want to
see a good series.
I just want to see a good series.
Yeah.
I'm more a fan of a good series than Travis. Let's
see.
What
does that even mean?
Who do I think's got it, though?
Oh, thank God!
That is a man witch if I've ever seen one.
That was close. A little shift there, eh?
I think I'll go with... I'll go with Kirklin. I think he's got it.
We can blame the rain on that one, Travis.
How about you?
I feel like Travis is very dangerous right now.
Dangerous.
No, I mean,
in terms of, like, he might just attack Kirklin.
He might attack him.
I might if I fucking lose man.
But, you know, Kirklin is really bringing it.
Woo!
Oh, slap
that ass. Kirklin right now.
I mean, I was not expecting that comeback when Kirklin he got in there and he was like, fuck off, and he got it.
Oh, yeah, that's exactly what he did.
That's exactly what he did. He said it anyway.
Alright. Oh, wow.
Let's go. You know, that happens.
Good job by the defense. Minus 2 yards.
Minus 2. It's not what you want.
The HB flip screen. Oh, cover 3 sky.
So we got Mayo over there.
Mayo.
Yeah.
Like mayonnaise.
Yeah, he's named after mayonnaise. His parents love mayonnaise so much.
I never understood this rule.
2 minute warning. Seven. Personnel.
So this is what, like halftime?
No, it's just a...
Yeah, they're gonna take a little break, have some orange slices, you know, recharge.
I miss those days.
Good times, man. It's good for the electrolytes. Okay. Yeah, nice try.
No way!
Why would you go off the field?
It stops the time. I get more time at the ball.
Oh.
I guess there's strategy in there, but I don't see it.
Fuck you! God, Taylor!
Your belt there really reflects light just all over the
room. I know,
room.
I'm trying to shine it in the corner of his eye.
That's not fair.
Wow. No. Did you hear that, fans?
I wouldn't do that. You know, the light is shining.
Wow.
It's reflecting.
This is baloney.
But I'm shining the light. I'm shining the light up there because, you know, I'm not salty enough to
shine the light.
If you lose that target in this room, I may fire you. I have the power now.
To fire me.
Yeah.
If he fires me, then he gets the belt back. That's a
I said
conspiracy.
If you lose, I'm a man of my word, you bitch.
I won't let him do that to you.
Thank you, thank you.
You don't have the control!
God damn.
I have the capture card.
I'll buy a new one.
Cool.
We got the power of the fans on our side.
Zero Blitz. You know what that one is?
What is that one?
Well, it's the Zero Blitz, and you know why it's named that?
Why is that?
Thomason Zero.
Thomason Zero?
Yeah, he's one of the greatest players of all time.
Really?
He was more about the strategies, more than, you know, he wasn't that good of a runner, I'll be honest with you. But yeah, he had many blitz techniques.
Blitz?
There's zero blitz, there's a 0-1 blitz,
there's
a 0-2 blitz.
Shaking in his shoes.
All the way up to the 0-12.
There's no 13 though.
No. 7 is my favorite, personally.
Why, what's 7?
It just, like, pretty much your whole team runs backwards, and then you all run forwards, and then you do it again, and it just confuses them. They think they're in some sort of weird psychotic dream, but really they're just getting 0-blitz 7.
That sounds intense.
Yeah, you should.
Come on!
So you think Travis is going to get it here?
Come on!
Right up almost to the touchdown. Zone.
Yeah, I mean, I don't really know what kind of counterplay there is, so it's hard to say.
So it
looks like he could.
He could, yeah. This is very intense.
He still has a few yards to go, though. Oh, he's going to go for the
run.
But
Kirklin's rocking that defense.
He's rocking that D. Yeah, he had the whole squad showed up. See, that's 6 dudes.
That's 6
They
dudes.
Had their beers there ready to party.
Oh, yeah. Crack open a cold one.
Crack open a cold one.
Do you know?
What'd you say?
Will the accelerated clock, like, ever fuck you over and just, like, end that?
Sometimes, or it could get down to, like, right to 5 seconds. Okay. And
he is right on that touchdown line.
Uh-huh. That's actually against the rules.
It is.
Fuck off! Oh, timeout!
Let's go!
Unbelievable.
Travis is calling a timeout. Do you want me to get you an orange slice, Travis?
Fuck orange slices.
Alright.
No, none for you. A 3rd and 9.
Oh, we got Tony Stark over here, right next to Rodgers. See that?
Starks, yeah.
Yeah.
Rodgers, do it.
Okay.
Oh, let's go.
Kirkland's just reading
yeah,
it.
Yeah, that was a very low-level play by Travis.
Fuck.
So
I think Travis is losing some confidence, whereas Kirkland just seems to be picking up momentum.
He is.
I think on Kirkland's next... chance to move forward. I don't know what the fuck it's called. He'll really pull through.
He will. But look, how does that work? He just gets a free kick like that?
No, I can't.
He gave up the chance to go for the touchdown.
That's not the fucking rule. Oh.
So it's a safer, it's a safer play because he can't get the touchdown, but at least he can get some free points.
Yeah,
so.
He's
doing,
got 3 points.
So wow. It's kind of like the coward's way out, but
it's called strategy.
Some people call it strategy. Some people call it cowardice. You know, it's just,
it
it's up to you.
Right, yeah.
So this is a nice big bunt right here.
So now Kirkland's going to get his touchdown here.
Well, maybe not immediately, but I think within...
he has 6 seconds, and then it's halftime, and that means he loses possession of the field, and then we switch sides. So.
6 seconds to get a touchdown.
That's not
this
fair.
Is nuts. This is
easy.
Who made
this?
This
is easy.
Look at my men. They're all spread out.
Look at my men.
I got a lot of men.
Oh no.
Oh, that's just.
Oh, yeah!
But it's okay because it doesn't matter in 1 second. Why didn't it matter? The timer ran out.
I think it goes to the end of play.
If I could have got in there.
Well, these are those wrestling moves.
It's kind of like how if you play basketball and you throw it in the air and like time runs and you get it in. You know,
but see, that's different because it wasn't.
Oh, that guy's hitting up the treadmill on the go. Nice. Good for him. All right, so now switches right back to Travis's turn.
That's why I went for the three.
Pretty imbalanced, but you know.
That's the way it goes. Those. What?
Is there even a coin toss?
That's like the beginning. The computers do it.
Oh, okay. Back in my day, we used to do the coin toss.
Back in the day.
Back in my, you know, if you're playing Wii Sports, you could physically do the coin toss.
Fucking runs. Stop giving me runs.
The Z-spot.
The Z-spot's a good one.
Really, what is that?
It's well, as good as it's the follow-up to the G-spot, yeah. I took my joke, what a bastard. Oh, we see that triangle. Oh, what are these triangles? Take me to Egypt.
Go, go, go!
Go, go, go!
Oh!
Oh!
Come on!
That rain playing a part again.
Let's go.
Yeah, that rain is just really just getting everywhere.
Yeah, it hits the best of us.
It's the best
of us. It's the best of us.
I mean, it's pretty hard to not get hit by it. You know, I'd like to see a football player take the initiative and bring an umbrella on field in conditions like this.
Yeah, totally.
Yeah.
Plan ahead. Oh, is Kirklin's involved for the intercept? Oh, but Travis is playing safe.
Yeah, that was a bad idea.
Oh, but he got punted.
That one guy just did a full flip. So we're on the 3rd and 5 right now.
3rd and 5 of the third quarter.
Yes.
With 4 minutes. Yeah! 4 seconds. Look at that. That ball went really far back.
The ball did.
Was it a sack or did you throw it?
I threw it in time. Thank God.
Thank God. We got the PR middle.
Nothing with that.
Good D. Good D.
No, don't give me that.
Now he's gonna.
Good computer. Boot it.
A good old,
the old kickerino.
There you go. There.
Did you call for a fair catch?
Triangle.
What a catch.
Oh yeah. Just the whole.
Break his legs. Break his legs.
That was a pileup.
It's my plan, I was just like putting gold players
in. Throw a headbutt and then scruff. Oh man, I haven't been on offense in a while.
It's effective 63% of the time in games. I don't know what that means.
Those aren't good odds.
They are good odds. The Z shallow cross. From the 26, that must be the line that they're at, the 26th line.
Must be.
Oh dear.
Oh,
that's scary. Every time it's in the air.
These guys have very little forward thought. They just throw it right into the enemy team every time.
That's the plan, I guess. Just play pass with the enemy.
So yeah, Kirklin's on offense here. He's currently down 3 points, so a touchdown here would be hella sweet.
It would be.
Put him up. Okay. No, not quite. He got a little bit of yardage.
If he got a touchdown, it would bump up to 6 or 13 points.
He's the same play again because he got triangle a bunch of stuff. He's gone it now.
This is a plan.
He's set up. Look at that.
Boom.
Look at that.
Got the ankle.
Good yardage.
Yardage.
Break that ankle. I want to see that ankle.
No, I just
shattering.
Got the ankle.
Just snap
gonna...
the ankle.
I think Travis's strategy at this point is to break Kirklin's...
Yeah.
Break your ankle in a second.
Their ankles and stuff.
Oh,
okay, so Kirklin's going for one of my favorite plays here. It's called the Praying Mantis. And...
It's a martial arts technique.
No. It originated in football.
Really?
So
what
you see here is he's waiting, and he chucks it to the guy to the left. And this guy...
Oh! What's going on, defense?
See that?
I swapped.
See that? Yeah, he just tackles three guys at once. Yeah.
Praying Mantis. Tom Brady.
He does the jabs.
The jabs.
Yeah.
And a first down, too.
Tom Brady is a good football player. I know that name.
I think I've heard of that name.
Fuck!
But yeah.
Oh, he had a sack there, too.
Give me a sack. You know, I like hacky sack. I think it's a much better sport than football.
It is. Hacky sack 18 is coming out next year.
Really?
Oh, damn!
My God.
I didn't even see that.
Almost a fumble. One second sooner, too.
Kirkland's really giving it his all right now.
And I'm not?
No.
Oh, you let the ball get this far.
Wow.
It's not like I'm at zero. I'm fucking ahead right now.
He's fucking ahead. All right, what do we got here? Gronkowski's going to the other side of the field.
Nice try. Dear. Ooh, brick fucking wall.
Brick wall waterfall.
Oh, and he lost 3 yards, too.
Travis thinks he's got it all.
Who do you think's thinking more ahead right now, Travis or Kirkland?
Ahead in what sense?
And like ahead, like in this, like their plays and their setup and getting those touchdowns.
I don't know. I think they're both taking the
ball. Yes! Come on,
Peppers.
Punt it? Oh, solid, you're going to go punt for it, eh?
He's solid, Veggie.
He's going for a punt.
No, he's not.
No.
He's going for the I form.
See, does this seem unfair? Because the person next to you, your opponent, can see your play you're going for.
You can also change. No, but you can also change that when they're not looking as well. Yeah.
When they're not looking. Which Travis is looking, so
no, but I mean,
unfair.
Like, shut up! Oh, come on!
Yes!
Fuck yeah, no. Delete!
Delito burrito.
So he's a good like 40 seconds left, or 21 seconds left. How about that?
And then 5 minutes after.
21 seconds, 40, and then 35 seconds. There's a lot of clocks here.
Almost too many.
Almost too many.
Like, where's Taylor time? I don't see that.
I don't even see that.
All right. So Travis is now on the offense.
Go faster.
Go faster.
Do you think yelling at your teammates has any effect here?
Yes.
Tonight?
Yeah, I did plug in the mic, so the game can hear him.
Interesting.
4, 3, 2, 1, 0. Oh, come on.
Couldn't get off fast enough. Sorry.
Couldn't get off fast
enough. Travis is trying to stall. I mean, he's in the lead. He can do that.
So we're in the last quarter.
We are.
And Will Fork.
Will Fork.
Is up there. Oh! Oh!
Beautiful. Let's do it again.
I'm very, like, getting on the edge of my seat here.
I'd say you're pretty squarely.
Oh, are you kidding me? Two people could hold the fucking ball.
That's how we do it.
That
was my guys.
That was my guy. Kirklin's got some confidence.
I was screaming in your guys' ear. That's why he dropped.
Oh, wow.
You know, Kirklin may be down, but he's keeping it cool.
He's keeping it cool.
Like a young
cucumber. He knows he's going to win the next two games, so he might as well just throw this one and give it to Travis.
I don't know if that's what he's thinking, but if it is, good for him. Who knows? Wow, that defensive line did shit all.
Go, yeah! Let's go.
I don't even know where these lines are, where they're trying to get to, except the end of the field.
Really? Well, they're just trying to, you know, progress forward. I think that yellow line is an indicator of how far he wants to go. Because if he gets to that line, he gets to keep going.
Do you think it's unfair that they're playing on Travis's home field?
Wow.
Yes, I do. Yeah, because, you know, if we were on Kirkland's field, I think it'd be a nice sunny day. Might be a couple clouds in the sky, but it wouldn't be fucking raining.
It'd be a good rainbow.
We both signed the What the fuck was that?
That's how you blitz.
The boys are just getting close and intimate.
The boys balling.
Four verticals. I want to see it.
Four verts.
Don't listen to the coach.
Do you think it's weird why the timer still goes down while they're on the pause menu?
Yeah, I mean, that's pretty stupid, but...
How? This is a championship match. How are you supposed to focus? With Taylor in the background.
Yeah, I didn't have to actually be here, ladies and gentlemen. But Travis is like, you know what? You can come down and commentate.
I told him to stay away until I get the first room.
I'm going
to
come
down. No!
What is this?
Oh my god, he missed the swap.
What a catch by Douglas.
Oh my goodness.
Dougie.
Corliss, I mean.
Defense. Come on.
Prime time.
Cal's coming to me. First ever GeekVerse Sports Champion right here. Breaking records again.
No, it's funny. They're good in the game, but I don't remember the Packers being at the whatever.
No, they're garbage in real life. Mm.
They made the semifinals. Shut the fuck up.
Yeah, not the grand finals.
But they aren't the finals.
Did they win?
No, I think the Patriots made it to the finals, didn't they?
No, won this year. Patriots.
Yeah, they did. How about that?
Yeah, okay.
They went in this year, but...
So this is apparently a separate timeline.
Yeah.
Oh, what a kick
Packers
by Douglas.
Next year.
So Kirkland just needs to get, like, a solid 2 touchdowns.
He really has to pop off quite hard.
I think he can do it.
I think he has a chance, but he'd have to play out of his mind.
Out of his mind.
He's going to have to pick the strong plays. I think the 4 verticals would be a perfect time to whip that out.
The turtle play, yes.
The turtle play, yeah. I think a couple gainers would be... he could gain her right over the whole enemy team.
What the fuck, you guys?
Wow.
You guys, what the fuck? Why is he just wide open?
Kirklin just—he's just holding out and he's just waiting for. His
oh moves. My god!
You know he's. I said he needs to play out of his mind, and he just got an amazing play. Just crispy. You can tell that Kirklin, you know, like in the, I'm thinking back in the locker room, like Travis just yells at his team and he complains, whereas Kirkland's like, here guys, have some orange slices. And I think that really shows in how much these players are dedicated. Because right there, there's no reason for Travis's guy not to cover him, but he's like, you know what, I fucking hate my coach, so I'm gonna not, I'm not gonna obey his commands.
2 minutes and 45 seconds. God damn.
Okay, big kick by Stewart.
Brushing
away some
blood. On the one? No! I was, yes! Oh, no, I was doing a sick hit! I wanted to...
Travis is just really losing it here.
God damn it!
Kirkland gets it back?
No, I just have to start really close to my...
Oh, you don't want to be in this spot, ladies and gentlemen.
I want a fair... Oh my god!
Yeah, this does not look good.
This does not look good. But I mean, he is still in the lead, but... One
nice,
good
nice.
Interception.
Let's get the fuck out of the corner. Let's get the fuck out of the corner.
I don't think he's really in the corner. I'd say he's more
in the center of the field.
Yeah.
Adjacent.
But, you know, teach their own.
Yeah! Let's go.
What a play by Franklin.
16-17.
What a play. This guy is going for gold. He's not going to settle for second.
Are you fucking kidding me? No. No.
Oh,
I hit the button. It didn't throw shit.
So all he needs is one point. And that could be like a punt or a touchdown, like
field goal.
Oh, man.
Fuck.
I was not expecting that, but I
no,
mean, at the same time,
I was. Huge plays by Kirkland.
Fuck!
The Prowl
Fuck.
Bear, number two.
Fuck!
You can just feel the rage
in
Travis's.
But
Travis's
Kirkland's
larynx.
Not putting any rage out. I mean, I
no.
feel like Kirkland would shake Travis's hand right now.
He's
if
keeping
he lost.
It, he's keeping it calm, he's keeping it easy. You know, he has a hat on that says, what happens on Earth stays on Earth. I feel like that's
very true.
His entire game plan right now
is
based upon that hat.
Look
oh,
at him go.
Some jukes? Okay.
Oh.
Oh, he just broke that guy's back.
Fucking Christ.
Just walk it off.
Berries.
Just walk it off.
So we're 2 minutes left in the fourth quarter here.
2 whole minutes.
You're fucking kidding
and
me.
And it's in Kirkland's possession, which is exactly what he wants right now.
Yes. Yeah, he could really do a variety of things to get these points.
Oh, he dropped it. Yes.
Yes.
Yeah, incomplete, baby.
Yes.
Are you still rooting for Kirkland here? Are you feeling like you're going to change to Travis? Or?
I think it would be a pretty great comeback.
An underdog story.
You could say that, yes.
Holy shit.
That's not what you need, though.
He's getting very close here.
I tasted the fucking ball.
He might have to go for a kick.
He might have to.
Come on,
I'd hate to see him do it this far away.
But, you know, he went for that big play before... Two big plays, actually, and they both worked out.
Yeah,
so.
And he's got at least, like, almost 2 minutes left. That's a lot of time, since you only get 4 seconds of game time every 10 minutes.
Oh, you sound like a wrestling
No!
Ref.
Well, you're gonna punt it, you're gonna field goal, you're gonna go for four, what you gonna do, sir?
So
well, they want
make...
you, the coach wants you to go for it? Fuck the coach.
Kirkland's gotta make a big decision here.
Yeah, he does, but yeah, I think he can do it.
Oh my god, you're going.
The thing you gotta keep in mind is if it goes back to Travis right now, like, there's still enough time on the clock for Travis to
get
another touchdown.
No! Come on,
but he's not feeling happy right now.
Well, I know what Coach is going for here.
He's going for the quad pats. Pats are.
Yes! Yes!
Oh.
Come on!
Holy cannoli.
I don't really know what happened.
Oh, let's see this.
I think he dropped it.
He was wide open.
Butterfingers.
Tally-ho!
That's the first time I've seen Kirkland actually get a little salty here.
Yeah, you can definitely feel the disappointment in his tone.
Yeah.
So there's only 1:21 left.
And somehow, is it in... Whose possession is it?
Mine now.
I don't know how that works, but okay.
Because he needed to make that play.
He needed to make the play.
Look at that, run right into first down.
I feel like it might be out of Kirkland's hands here. Unless he pulls some deke dangling
Damn.
Duke right out.
Deke dangling Duke. Oh, big buttons.
Big buttons indeed. Oh, a trophy. Click off the block.
Nice for user one. It's my second favorite profile.
Oh, yeah. I don't know if you
can take
it.
What's your first?
Yeah, anytime.
Slurms. Slurms McKenzie is the name.
I want no fucking excuses from anybody in the comments. From Taylor.
That was fair play.
Second down. We got Mayo over there.
Every time I win, so I'm like, ooh, no respect. I'm changing
everyone's mind. Oh, with rules like these, it's kind of hard to respect.
With rules like these. He's just running for it. He doesn't even care at this point.
Fucking hell.
Timeout. It's like we're like little kids again.
You were never not a little kid.
Oh, look, it's Taylor. Look at Taylor on the field. I'm on your team, Travis.
Oh my god. I totally
didn't know. That's his last name.
Oh, you're right.
But they are on a field.
They
so
are on a field.
Combine that guy's name with the thing they're standing on and boom, you have Taylor Field.
You know there's a football field named Taylor Field?
I did. That's why I'm surprised you don't know more about football.
Exactly. I don't know.
Because that was the very first catch. You're like, hey, I'm named after a football field. Check me out.
Check me out.
All right, what's Travis gonna go for here?
He's go for
he might as well just
punt.
Pop off. I mean, he's got
pop off.
I'm not
punt.
Gonna pop off and risk the ball going back to Kirklin.
Is pop off actually a football move?
Yeah.
Really? Is that where that term comes from?
Yeah, it's named after Jonathan Popoff.
Jonathan Popoff.
I'm upset with my play making.
Don't worry, Kirklin. We believe you over here.
We believe in you.
We believe in
you.
You filthy liar. That's exactly how you wanted the play to go. Lacey. And another one.
Get back.
So we got 5 seconds on the clock. Four, three.
Oh, that catch.
And a winner.
A winner.
Mm-hmm. Trying to get a score.
All
right. Travis is really determined to get something out of these 2 seconds.
He's just playing for the BM card right now.
Mm-hmm. Do you think he can last 2 seconds? Or are you going to...
I don't think he's ever lasted that long.
Oh! Oh!
What is this leg position?
Just the cherry on top.
Oh!
Oh, he doesn't even have to hold the controller.
But you know.
Oh,
he shouldn't be this happy because the whole game was very close.
Yeah,
and he just
that's why I'm happy. I'm going on a game.
Nice effort by both players.
I'd be happy if I wrecked the field. But now you know we're gonna go to the next game here.
Now we're moving on to UFC.
Mm-hmm.
Who's who? Who's who?
I am John Jones, the red gloves.
John Jones.
All right, here we go. Hopping into game two here, Taylor.
We can't fuck around this
game. We got Travis playing John John, and we got Kirklin playing. Help me out here, Kirklin.
Anderson Silva.
I feel like Anderson Silva is a pretty good guy.
He's not a very
so you
good
actually know UFC, as opposed to
a
not
bit.
Anything about football.
I know a little bit about
I
UFC.
Don't know anything about UFC.
I used
so
to do kickboxing, actually. I did it for about 3 years.
I'd like
years.
To see that.
It was definitely a while ago.
That must have been a sad sight.
I didn't like punching people. You know, I'm a lover, not a fighter.
But you'd kick people, no problem.
Yes. I was. That's why I was good at soccer.
I skipped the entrance. Can you punch him before you touch gloves?
So, yeah, here we go. Okay, give me a quick rundown of what the screen's telling us here. So, I'm guessing those are like the stamina bars or something at top?
Yeah, it looks like it is.
So,
how do you win?
How
you win? You basically want to just, I think you want to knock it on the other person.
You want to knock him out.
You want to knock him out.
That just sounds unhealthy.
I think there's pinning too you can do as well.
Ooh,
that you can
submitting.
Do. Submitting, that's it. Maybe even a good punt every now and then.
Just every now and then. Yeah.
Fuck around, guys.
All right, so Travis really likes to use his legs because that guy has quite the leg span. Look at all the range he has. Kirklin looks like he's kind of just playing the defensive game and then goes for a big old punch when he gets the opportunity.
Big old punch.
You want to do this, Travis?
You're just going for it. Look at him dancing. Oh, he's got the foot around there. Look at that. And there's the submit.
So, Taylor, does the fact that both their heads are highlighted red mean anything
this?
In the top right and left?
I think that they're both
damaged.
What is this?
They're damaged, yeah.
What is this?
You have to hold the sides.
Oh my god!
His arm is gonna break off here any second.
Yeah, that looks really painful.
Oh my god.
Oh yeah!
Now they're hugging. Oh! Oh!
Wow. I think you're
fine. You're doing it. That's me.
What?
Oh my god. No!
Well, now they're just both just cheating each other out here.
Hit it. Hit X. Okay. There we go.
Oh, there we go.
Wow.
Not doing that again.
Disqualified.
Kirkland's trying to get out of it. He's worried. That's a big one. Welcome to the jungle. The most sad fight ever.
Taylor, I need your help. I don't know this game.
I'm trying to catch up because this is just like foots everywhere.
A lot of feet.
But you know, I mean, the main point, yeah, you want to deal enough damage here to your opponent, and then you want to get them on the ground.
No!
And when they're on the ground, you submit them. And then, real seconds, unlike wrestling, you win.
Yeah.
Fuck off.
Cool.
Ooh.
So Anderson over here, Kirkland's body is now highlighted red. It means he's fired up and ready to fight.
It is. He's getting fired up.
Well, I don't know what
like
that.
He's gonna pull some Goku moves out of his.
This is very sensual.
It is. They're almost like dancing with each other.
Yeah. That's what I meant.
Kick him in the nuts.
Yeah, that's legal.
Oh, that's dirty, Travis.
That's just
anything to win.
Not cool.
Anything to win. You hear that, ladies and gentlemen?
Oh! This is what?
Just to the boobs and
oh!
Well, is this it? Like that's it.
Know. I'm guessing based on this pop off that Travis won.
I think so. So I know,
told you.
I was expecting it was a few rounds or
whatever. Oh,
goodness.
I told you. I'm the best. If I can't win one time, I'm gonna win the other. Woo! Oh!
Ladies and gentlemen, we have our first sports Gauntlet Championship winner, Travis Snell.
Oh.
And I feel like I can feel the emotion. I can't believe it.
That was something.
We're not going to Wii Sports.
No, we're
not. No, we're not. I was going to order a pizza
first
and enjoy
ever knockout.
It. Woo! I'm not lost for words.
I didn't think it was over, but
I don't really know what happened.
Well, Kirkland, like, that was a serious turn of events there. I mean, how do you feel about him being your mystery opponent, first of all?
I don't know. I don't really feel anything. Like I said before, it didn't really matter who I was going to face. It was a loud opponent. He was a loud opponent.
Yes.
Can't speak. Yeah.
Yeah, so I mean, you know, I felt very confident in you with that Madden game there. You did really good. You held
your own. That was just a couple unlucky turns. I felt like just some RNG fest going on. I had no idea what was going on.
Mm-hmm.
Just some very unlucky plays.
Mm-hmm.
I felt like there wasn't too much more I could do. I did make a little mistakes here and there, which I could have fixed.
Yeah, and then you know, this is your game, isn't it? UFC.
Yeah.
Yeah. So how do you feel about this?
Really, I have no idea what happened. I felt like he got some nipple shots in and my guy was just down. I'm not too sure.
Yeah, well, you know what? He won that belt. Whether it was, you could say, fair and square, I don't know at this point, but he's got it. So, you know, I'm gonna shake your hand because you did a great job.
Thank you.
I don't know if he shook your hand. I'm going to have to watch the replay after. I think he took his belt and he's down the street. I think I saw him run off to 7-Eleven and get himself his lime slushy. But yeah, you know, I look forward to seeing you in some more Gauntlet action. Especially some sports Gauntlet championships.
Thank you, yes. It was a fun tournament, I will admit.
Yeah, you did good.
Thank you. Thank you, Taylor.
All right, here I am with the winner of our last match. The first ever winner of the sports title. How does that feel, first of all?
You know what? That feels great. I gotta admit, when we had the tournament, I wasn't happy to lose, but the worst thing was you got that official title being the first ever. There's not, there's only one first ever for a title. And now in the history books, years later,
this is like the first ever's little brother, you could say.
It is, but it doesn't matter. It's the first ever of a title. It's the second title of Geek vs. Gauntlet. When my kids look in the future history books, they're going to see first ever Geek vs. Gauntlet sports champion.
Yeah, that was probably better half because it can fit in your pocket.
What? I can take it anywhere for autograph signings. I can take, you know,
I don't need to spend on the budget for any more titles. I'm using that for my limousines. I'm using that for promoting, for the bitches.
So let's talk about the game. You started off with Madden, which is your game.
Mm-hmm.
How did that go for you? How do you think it went?
I honestly thought I was going to lose for the majority of the match.
Was it when he got that momentum shift and it was 16-17?
I never felt it come back until that one time I happened to like... And that's where you say the stats and I shouldn't have done it, but that field goal won it for me because I had those 3 points.
Mm-hmm.
I think I made a smart move of using the strategic route, but once the momentum turned, I always felt like I threw an interception. He threw a touchdown where no one was around. So really, he surprised me because I literally thought I was going to take Madden easily and he was going to take this easily. And he almost tapped me out in UFC, but in Madden, I was worried... other than 1 minute of the match, I was worried the whole time. Mm-hmm. So, and he's a very valuable competitor.
I think that shows in the game. It was very back and forth emotionally for you. How about UFC? I mean, it was very quick. It was like 4 or 5 minute match. But how was that?
All my strategy was, because I didn't know much of the controls, I've not played much UFC. I played it back in the day. My strategy was just to hit and hope for a knockout.
Yeah.
Luckily, that happened. He nearly tapped me out, like I said. But my idea was just to... just keep hitting him and hit him as much as possible and hope to, because sometimes in these games you get like a fluke knockout,
mm-hmm.
and maybe that's what it was, and maybe that's why he's going to be a little salty, but you know what? It happened, so.
Let's say in another world this did go to a third game. How do you think Wii Sports would have fared?
I would have creamed him, you know, because, you know, other than Madden, you look at this, I just was playing UFC for the first time in 5 years, creamed him then. Madden, I think maybe I just got a little overconfident, because that's what I do, but I would have creamed him in this game just like I'd cream you or anybody else in any game in the world.
A lot of cream. So I have one more question for you. Nowadays in the Gauntlet, you are officially the chairman.
Mm-hmm.
You're also competing. I mentioned during the set that Kirklin had no idea who he's playing, yet you're kind of in the background. You kind of are the puppet master, if you will. Do you think that that's fair, that you are the chairman and also a competitor?
Well, I take from it from two stances. A personal stance, if I don't have a title, I want to be winning, I want to get another title. And yeah, I said I'd put that aside, but you know what? I think the people want to see me, and at the end of the day, it doesn't matter. I run it. I'm going to run this place a whole lot better. My plan is just to take over. I hope Taylor loses his title later. And you know what? People can say it's a little unfair or whatnot, but that's life, ladies and gentlemen. Life sucks, and then you die. But luckily for me, I'm the sports champion. And if you don't like it, suck it, because I'm in here for a long time. I'm never going to lose this. The only way they could take the title from me last time was that dope Kyle Smith, who I got, like, I dispatched earlier. That fucking dope. He had to put me in a six-way match to lose the title. That's the only way I lost the title. That's never happening again as me as a chairman. Kirk can get a rematch, Kyle can come back, you can face me, you're all going to be kissing my boots. Taylor, you're never going to face me, because you're going to lose to Reuben, and hopefully I'll fire your ass once your contract's up.
Wow.
People can say it's not fair, and you know, whatever. Kirkland showed that he's a great competitor, but you know what? He wasn't better than the best.
Awesome.
Wow. Congratulations, Travis.
What are you even doing? You should be getting ready. You have a huge match against Reuben. You know, thank goodness I won a title. You look at the title lineage. Dylan held that title first ever time he won a tournament. I defended it, became the longest reigning champion. I am the first ever champion of this. And now somehow we have you. You as the champion.
Yeah, look how puny that belt is. The third time's the charm.
It's,
right here.
It's not about the size. It's about the quality. What are you doing to... I just have to say that you are... Are you drunk?
No. I'm drunk on championship.
Well, I just have to say that you are going to go out there tonight and prove that you are the biggest paper champion of all time. Reuben is undefeated. He's going to destroy you. He's going to wipe the floor with you. And I cannot wait to announce him as the new Geek vs. Gauntlet champion. I can have a current partner champion I can be proud of.
Oh, you know what? You wish. This is the first... That's second. I'm coming for that. The next chance I get, I'm going to get that from you. I'm wearing one up here, and I'm going to wear this guy right here.
You couldn't beat me without the help of 4 other people. And you know what? I'll give you this. Maybe you can prove me wrong and prove all of them wrong, and maybe you can beat Reuben tonight. But if you do, I promise you one thing. That next season, I'm the chairman. I'm going to make your life a living hell.
You bring it. I got my hell right here, my Hail Mary, and it's gonna come down on you, and I'm just gonna get that belt. I'm gonna win.
I need this win, especially against Travis.
he did finish last in the GeekVerse Gauntlet.
A little bit more.
But.
Wow.
Come on. One more kill, and Tyler has not only won this game.
And it looks like the time's gonna run out.
It's because you suck! All you do is make excuses! Everybody else is beating you too!
Maybe I have to retire from gaming altogether. I'm gonna have to do some serious in-depth thought.
You're definitely back in the lowest ranking now after this defeat. There's another loss. Where do you go from here?
Recovery!
I'm not out of this fight yet.
And he takes it! Yes! Ladies and gentlemen, that is it!
I mean, this goes to show that even losers can become winners. So don't give up.
Okay?
Whatever you say.
This is awesome.
My mystery opponent, somebody that I've recruited, somebody that, you know, I think could bring a lot of talent to the GeekVerse Gauntlet. Reuben! Paulson!
I shouldn't believe you. Fuck! You had your hopes up that it was gonna be somebody you'd be able to meet.
So, either way, you're looking forward to versing your friend Reuben because you guys have a long history. You guys co-host podcasts together, multiple podcasts. You guys have known each other for years. He didn't actually really want to be here. He said that he actually didn't want to waste his time with you, and he actually said that he wanted me to pass something along to you.
I think I know what this is. Why does Reuben have this? This is Pence Polos?
Well, today when he beats Taylor Field in Smash, I'm unsuspended, and the GeekVerse Gauntlet is under my control.
I've told you for weeks,
I'm not Pence.
That man that was sitting next to you, the man that screwed Kyle, thank God he's not here, and you out of that match and beat you as champion, was Reuben Olsen. Reuben Olsen was under that mask the entire time during Smash, and he told me to tell you that, you know what? What's on your shoulder right now means a lot more than your friendship.
Holy shit, Reuben. Seriously, what the fuck? I'm not being, like, unexpected here with his appearance. I know what he's capable of. Half these games, I know what he's gonna try and pull, and half these games, I know I'm confident. I'm really having to give it my all to win this.
I screwed up Taylor once before by helping Travis take control of the Gauntlet. I'll screw him up again by taking his title.
Alright, ladies and gentlemen, it is our time for the main event. Introducing first, the challenger at 5-0, the undefeated Reuben Olsen!
Wow.
There's only one man in this world I wouldn't want to fight. That's me, brother! That's me!
He is ready to go. He is ready for him to become
6-0. Ah.
He's ready to become 6-0. My God. And introducing next, the champion, the mentor, the GeekVerse Gauntlet champion, Taylor Field! All decked out, Assassin's Creed. This is very fitting. This man, oh, host, he's together. Oh man,
I'm gonna kick your butt.
Templars weren't a problem. The geeks weren't a problem. You're not gonna be a problem.
You're going down, brother.
Nope, I'm only going up.
Oh
Alright, so these guys are picking their course now, but we have, I believe, Taylor Field playing as Waluigi, and Reuben playing as the one and only Wario.
Yes.
So, the duel between, obviously, the evil guys in the Mario series and the
Mario's cousins,
and
actually.
The evil guys on the Geek Screen.
Mm-hmm.
Cousins, right? Really?
That's...
I can see, like, Dementia Uncle.
I legitimately think they are cousins. I'm not even lying, actually. I think they
really?
Are. Yeah. But here it is. This is the first round. Yeah. So if you still haven't heard, it's a best of five. Not this. This is who's going to win the first three, or like it's best of three. So we're going to win the first two.
First two races, yeah.
A lot on the line here because who can win this Mario Kart series can get 1 point in the best of five series. So
right.
A lot on the line. Reuben's undefeated.
You always
streak.
Want that lead.
Yeah.
It gives you confidence. It
mm-hmm.
takes pressure off.
Yeah.
For sure.
You feel a bit more secured. Like you feel like, oh, I can lose one because I'm up one already.
Yeah.
But if you're down, that'll hurt. And losses on the line. Taylor's title is on the line. Reuben's undefeated streak is on the line. Something's going to break here. I've been very excited for this match for weeks. All
mm-hmm.
GeekVerse has been very excited.
They go with Wan Lan, or what is this called? Moo Moo Meadows, I think it is.
Mm-hmm.
This is a classic. This is from the N64 Mario Kart, I believe,
mm-hmm.
originally.
All the rest of the GeekVerse members are not here because they wanted to give these two the privacy
mm-hmm.
of this, so they're all going to be watching this at the same time as you.
This has been pretty uneventful so far.
And, okay, so Reuben as Wario. I was going to say, Reuben has notoriously, even from hearing from Taylor a few weeks, that Reuben's a good Mario Kart player. But Taylor's
but,
not too far
but,
behind.
But would Taylor say that Reuben's a garbage Mario Kart player?
No, he said no. He said he's good.
I know, but what I'm saying, like, would Taylor say that, though?
Oh. No, but I think that...
Okay, here we go. Taylor... Wow, he is actually probably way.
I'm saying when he found out when we did the choice for Mario Kart, he legitimately looked concerned when Mario Kart came up. And he was the champ, so he got to choose champ's choices, champ's advantage. You always get to choose the types. So if it's Call of Duty, you can choose which one.
Right.
So he chose this one.
Oh.
I think it was smart, because the old one is very unpredictable. The controls are very...
No!
Cool. For the first time, Taylor Phil is taking the
Those
lead in this race.
Damn cows, man.
Wow. Cows always so...
And that's on the third lap, too, so he could have snuck in right at the end, and that could be it.
This could be a good advantage for the Mario Kart round. Well, oh my god!
Beautiful green
Taylor
shield from Taylor.
Field.
That was calculated. This guy got his protractor out and he angled that.
Yeah,
straight at Wario's mode.
Wow. Is this it?
And I believe this was Taylor's map pick, so this is a good thing.
Wow.
That this
so
year.
Taylor Field is up one of the best of three of Mario Kart. Good this is
fun.
Very surprising. Taylor Field, who's had a very tough season the whole time, he's been the ball most time. He won the title, but even then, many people are questioning the title. There's six other people involved. He has a lot to prove, and I think beating Reuben's undefeated streak, that could be a big cap in his feather. That's huge. No one has beaten Reuben yet in
exactly.
the gauntlet.
Can you
so, truthfully, I'm surprised. I thought Taylor was going to get creamed in Mario Kart, to be honest. I did not think he had stood a chance against
well,
Reuben.
Well, let's not get ahead of ourselves here. We're
True.
One game in, and that was Taylor's pick, and now Reuben gets a pick.
And this is very much...
Does he go with Rainbow Road?
Yes.
One, just a quick spoiler, I can barely see Taylor's side of the screen, so I'm mostly watching Reuben.
Do you want me to move over?
No, it's all good.
Okay.
I didn't see enough.
Okay.
I'm the most important side to watch anyways.
Oh, wow.
Oh, this guy's
wow.
got some confidence
yeah,
going
yes.
around, too.
A big mouth.
Rainbow Road.
To have.
This is a classic.
Now, we did see this a few weeks back, when, or a few months back, when I versed Tyler for the title, where Smash was his favorite. I took the first round, and I was very confident, but I think that confidence, I maybe got a little too confident, because I thought, oh, I beat him, I can beat him again. I hope Taylor does suffer from the same, because
right.
I don't
well,
want
well,
him
sometimes,
to lose.
Sometimes, yeah, sometimes it does work the opposite, where... Winning the first game adds pressure for you to feel like you know you need to perform, and if you can't do it, that can scar you for life.
But truthfully, I hope he doesn't perform, because I want Taylor Field to lose this. I'm the new owner of Geek Gauntlet, and I don't want Taylor Field as my champion. I've been very clear.
Oh, okay.
So
well, that's not helpful. Oh, you actually get back on the track pretty damn quick.
Mm. So Reuben is in the lead right
oh,
now. Big fall though.
That was a bad idea.
Oh, Taylor takes the lead again. Taylor is being.
He's playing safe. He's sneaking in there.
He's a lot of wherewithal right now. Yeah, he's...
Reuben's going... He's putting a little more on the line.
He's being fast and furious, and Taylor's being safe and curious.
Oh, interesting.
Oh.
Can't go in the middle.
Oh.
They both rumble up there.
Yeah, too bad, because Taylor could have really took advantage of that,
mm-hmm.
but then he got hit by the big block guy.
One thing I just noticed, actually, they're both using the bikes.
Mm-hmm.
Personally, when I play this game, I'm not a fan of the bike. It turns much quicker. You can't drift as well, though.
But this shows to me how similar these two are as opponents.
Yes, as
they're
human
great,
beings
they're
as well.
Great, yeah, they're great friends. They host a podcast together. They spend amounts of time together. So that
Oh, that's not good.
Oh!
Both of them. Okay, both of them, though, off the course.
That what seems
nice. Nice shell. Oh, nice.
Whoa! Double shell.
Double whammy.
Other than that time, it does seem to be when one screws up, the other screws up. So they haven't been taking advantage too much, but Taylor
you
did
know,
take advantage.
I would not be surprised if these guys were separated at birth. They could be twin brothers.
And that's why this match is so, I think, intense for these two.
Nice bananas by Reuben.
They're not just friends having a match. They're friends having a match with stakes. And I think that's definitely going to play in this. Do you think they'll be able to be friends after this? Because either Taylor ends the streak or he takes his title. I don't know if they can come back from that. That's a tough thing to swallow.
Well, here's the thing. Taylor, one of the nicest guys I've ever met. Mm-hmm. I don't think he's going to really take this too badly. But
a lot of people would say the same thing about you until you lost the title. And honestly, I think you're in a better place now. But
it does change
you. When I lost the title, you do feel it.
You can definitely see that because obviously Taylor is a veteran. And this is it right here.
Wow. Taylor has taken Mario Kart, I think, in
a clean 2-0.
Wow. Ladies and gentlemen.
Reuben visibly disappointed, shaking his head.
Yes. I wonder how this is going to affect Reuben going on, because he was favored in this. And now we're going to Pokken. A game that Taylor Field is very confident
in. I would say he probably has an advantage in it.
Wow, Taylor, look at
not
that smile
happy.
He just
that,
showed.
Not happy.
That's not a smirk. That's a full-on evil, menacing smile.
Even as someone that is not a fan of Taylor Field, many fans have said that he's become a new person getting the championship.
Right.
So, we'll see in Pokken coming up next. Oh, wow.
He's got
confident.
The blade out.
Round two.
Pokken, Taylor is up 1-0. He won Mario Kart.
A game two also, which he notoriously put in the OG Geeker Scotland. So, he's the one that...
He's been wanting to play this for months.
A made eligible
years
game. And once again, all these teams that were selected today were random. So, he got a luck of a draw here. And really luck of a draw because he won Mario Kart. I think we both didn't expect that.
Reuben has played this game.
Mm-hmm.
So, it's not a complete... Blowout, whereas sometimes, you know, Rocket League, for example, you've never played that game in your life, so it could be worse.
But to counter that, who is who, by the way, gentlemen?
I am Lucario.
Okay.
I'm Garchomp.
Okay. To counter that, though, Taylor has a specifically modded, made controller.
Yeah.
For
it's from Toys R Us.
I will say,
modded.
I will say that it is an official product, therefore it probably doesn't have any hacks on it. It probably just has, you know, some easier buttons.
Classic Taylor, like
some easier combos.
Okay, so here we go. Same as Mario Kart, they're doing a best of three in this. The winner will get one more point. And if Taylor gets that, he's up two and only needs to win one more.
Yeah.
If Reuben wins that, he can tie it all up.
So I personally only watched a little, like a couple streams of this game. I don't know a whole lot. I also can't see the health bars. So.
Mm. So who, which one? Oh, Taylor loses? Oh, I'm guessing that's Reuben's name, Taylor Reuben? Who is
Taylor? Taylor loses.
Taylor has been putting it in his
Wow.
I'm player two.
Taylor.
I'm stomped.
Reuben down to 42 HP. The answer to
Oh, he's making a little comeback.
Nice comeback. Oh my god, this is huge. This could be it.
I don't think so. I think Taylor's still going to find a way.
Whoa. Fire Cat comes in. Oh, look at this.
He's still alive.
Oh,
well,
this
I think
looks
that's
like
a
big
death sentence right there.
Six?
Yeah, I think that's going to be demo right there.
One?
No, the grab!
And zero, yeah. So there's first round.
Taylor, you want to move your chair a bit to your left?
I can see now.
Okay.
Saw that.
So now Taylor.
It's on mute.
Now Taylor needs to win just one more, and he's already taken Pokken as well.
That's true. And that would be huge, isn't it? And we're going to, you know, we have a few other rounds, but being up 2-0 means that Taylor just has to win one of the next three. So.
There's five games that were picked. We might not even get to the fourth game if Taylor can win this and get to movie top 20. So
what do you own a fist bump?
That, I think if Taylor can win
he is comboing Reuben right now.
If Taylor can win 3-0, he is proving a lot of doubt on his own. Even myself a little, who's doubted the whole time his whole existence I've known him, that's quite good. Reuben seems to be faring better this round, though, than he did last round, I will say that.
He is putting up a bit of a fight.
It is starting to go down there. Oof.
Okay.
Okay.
Burrow?
So he's doing some moves, but I think Taylor's too much to take. He almost. Do you think Taylor could have baited him in there?
Taylor can do some pretty wild things right now. He can, you know, take some trades, too, right? Just based on the health.
Oh, just
him.
Laying it in to Aquario.
Okay, well.
Is Reuben going to bring this back?
Can Reuben pull up an upset here? Oh, Taylor is fighting with everything he has.
Mega Lucario.
Oh no! Oh man, Taylor has beaten Reuben for 0.2. My god. Taylor takes
go
that.
Third round?
It does. We set it to three.
Okay, so it's not over yet.
How is it not over? What happens if the person wins the last one?
I think it's best of five. Sorry.
Oh, I thought it was over, but they're still going.
I feel like you make that mistake, on a semi-regular basis.
Me?
Yeah.
I feel like we all do. Well, I didn't know the... I thought it was like you... They've been for three rounds. Either way, we'll call the action. Taylor's up by two.
Okay, well, Reuben got an early lead here.
Mm-hmm. Oh!
Taylor's pouring down to a quick 120 HP.
Mm-hmm. So Reuben's faring much better in this round than he did previously.
Seems that he's just got the
combo. Oh! That's going to hurt you on a Monday morning.
On a Monday morning.
Taylor's not looking good.
Wow.
Reuben takes that round. Let's see, I do not know Pokken if
crazy.
He gets another one or if that was just a moral victory.
No,
Reuben.
It's first to 3 points, so.
Really?
Yeah. It's the best part.
It's strange, but they say you play 3 rounds. I guess you need 3 wins, I guess.
Yeah, I guess so. You pick how many rounds he's in.
So Reuben's not out of it yet. When he needed a win, he got it. He's showing improvement. Now, is this a case of Taylor maybe feeling a little overconfident?
Not necessarily. I think, Reuben, the way he was looking down at that gamepad, he means business.
Mm-hmm.
Like, he does not want to lose this.
No.
I think he realizes that he needs this win.
I don't know if he can come back from a 2-0 deficit to win.
Because after this, what do we got? We got some potential Battlefront, we got top 20, and what's the other game?
Goldeneye, if needed.
Goldeneye?
Yeah.
So Goldeneye is a risky pick. You don't want to have to go to that. You don't want to have to rely on winning that, right?
Mm-hmm.
So, once again, Reuben is down by quite a bit.
Quite
down
a
100
bit.
HP.
Mm-hmm. It's not looking good for him. He's fighting back, though.
Taylor's got some good combos, man.
Yeah.
I will admit.
But Reuben's not going down without a fight. He's trying his best.
Nice grab. This could be some big damage.
Oh! Just like a big
corner pressure.
Clap.
Okay. He likes that.
Oh!
That bum drop move.
Reuben is very close.
But look at this combo.
Wow.
Like he is all over Taylor.
Oh
right
man.
Now.
Is that
all it takes though?
Wow. Oh wow, Taylor.
3-1.
That was good.
Has now won the official point. He's up to, we're going into movie top 20, something that Reuben's not playing and something Taylor is not good at. This is Reuben's last shot. If he cannot win at top 20, Taylor has not only ended the undefeated streak, he has...
We're on match point here.
He has successfully defended the title.
My God.
How do you feel?
Wow.
Mad.
Both men get 10 minutes separately. They get 20 questions. They have to be yes or no questions. And they can hopefully get that movie in that 10 minutes. Whoever gets it sooner will win. If there's a tie, let's say if you both go on the 10th question, it'll be whoever got it quicker. So, Taylor, are you ready?
I'm ready.
All right. Dylan, hit the timer. Tell him when he...
1, 2, 3, go.
Okay, Apple of Eden. Let's do this. Is it 2010 or later?
Yes.
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 Yeah.
I don't have a lot of time to write that out fully.
Yeah, I know. You can just put 10,010 as an arrow, but
is it a sci-fi?
Yeah.
Yes.
Have I seen it?
Yes.
After 2 years, I've heard it mentioned at some point.
I saw it. Taylor's documentary. Sorry, I saw it.
Does it have a male lead?
Yes. Ladies and gentlemen, Taylor's turn on the fire. This is the most questions he's ever done, ever, I think. He usually has two and he's stumped.
He's getting the easy ones out of the way.
This is true.
Does it have aliens?
No.
No.
It's just a Taylor question.
Not a single alien.
You can tell he's really hoping for Star Wars or Star Trek.
I was fucking praying for something.
We're gonna make it that easy.
We have 15 questions.
No aliens. Male lead. I saw. 2010 or later. Sci-fi. What's my timer at?
8 minutes. And 10 seconds.
Folks, we've seen this before. Taylor walks up very easily.
Fucking hate movie trivia.
That's not a good sign. He's cracking under the pressure.
Arms.
Knees weak.
Yeah. Spaghetti. It would do you well to ask more questions. Narrow it down.
That's the problem. Thinking of the questions. That's the problem. 2010 or later. Does it take place in space?
No.
No.
Oh. Taylor really trying to lean back on his Star Wars love, but it's not helping him out here with no space and no aliens.
It's a sci-fi, probably. Did it come out in the past 2 years?
No.
No.
So Taylor's really trying to narrow down the date. Which could help him. Better than what he usually
does. I think he sometimes asks those questions as like a fallback.
True. You've asked 7 questions so far.
Is there a monster of some kind?
No.
No.
Again, ladies and gentlemen, the movie is geek related, so it's not all good. As you see, a sci-fi, a horror, a comic book,
no wrong
animation, no wrong cards, all anything that's geek related.
2010, 2015. Sci-fi, I saw it, male lead, aliens on space, a monster. Shit.
Time going?
5 minutes and 50 seconds.
That's fast 3 minutes for 2 fucking questions.
Taylor's getting frustrated.
Very, very much.
Because
so.
He knows if he gets this, he could maybe just clean sweep Reuben. But the thing is, he has to at least get it on some question, or Reuben could have a next one and just get it on the 20th question and still win.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, it's better just blow through all your questions and try your best, right?
Fuck, sci-fi with no aliens. I'm having trouble drawing up what that could be. Most of the sci-fis I do remember have aliens in them.
This is fitting, as this was how the very first GeekVerse Gauntlet Championship between you and Tyler was decided. So we're all the way back home here at GeekMania.
Right. Halfway through,
he's asking 8 questions, I believe.
Yep.
So you got 12
horrific
more.
Flashbacks here.
He's having flashbacks.
Does the storyline take place in the future?
No.
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 It means it's present day.
Don't worry about us laughing, you focus on
the
your...
more you know.
Well, that doesn't necessarily mean present day, also. It's just not
I'm gonna go with present day. I like the sound of that.
I'm just saying, like,
is it a comic book movie?
No. That's 10. You're halfway done your questions.
Present day. Past. Not comic. Is there a living opposing entity?
Yes, I guess so.
Is there?
What does that mean?
I would probably say that about any movie, though.
Yes,
so
was
there's a living being, is what you're saying, that is the enemy. So it's got something like that, like they're against something.
I'll say yes. We can't... If you want more clarification, you'd have to ask another question. But yes, there is...
I wouldn't bank your life on that.
Yeah.
Well, shit.
Nine more questions. And how much time?
3 minutes and 15 seconds.
You're getting it, Taylor. Okay. You start on this question.
Does it have a well-known male lead actor that I know?
Yes.
Oh, God.
I know him.
I was just writing, like, symbols.
How come it isn't a... not space. Sci-fi. Are there animals in it?
It's not
no.
a main feature. No,
I don't think
it's,
so.
No.
I can't remember an animal.
There could be a cat in an alley, but it's not something to do with the plot.
You
no.
can't tell him there's an alley.
No aliens, sci-fi, I saw it. What the fudge?
Well, Ruben's making a face over here like
Ruben thinks he
knows
it.
Yeah, we'll ask him, before I say, we'll ask Ruben if Taylor does not get it.
And then Taylor can do the reverse if...
Yeah,
okay.
Does that mean I get to steal the point?
No, you don't.
No aliens thing that's throwing me off here.
Why?
Because most of the sci-fi movies I know have aliens in them, so I can't recall last time I watched a sci-fi movie.
I didn't spend too much time talking. You got 2 minutes. Two more.
2 minutes.
Yeah, 2 minutes right now.
And I have 8 questions left.
Taylor has never completed a top one.
Are there other people with the male lead?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay.
One and a half minutes.
If I lose and I don't get it within the time, these don't matter, do they?
No. If you don't get it at all, it doesn't matter. You're at zero.
Okay. Is it between... Did it come out in the year 2013?
No.
Did it come out in the year 2011?
No.
Did it come out in 2012?
No.
Did it come out in 2014?
No.
What? It had to be between 2010 and 2015.
No.
That's what I narrowed it down to.
No, you said 2010 or forward.
Yeah, and then I said, did it come out 2015?
No.
Between 2015 to 2017.
Yeah, it's
you
still
have 40 seconds.
Fuck me. 40 seconds. Is it Jurassic World?
No.
No animals.
Fuck. I fucking hate this game. Fuck.
Does he only
How much time do I have left?
20 seconds.
20 seconds. Came in the last 2 years then? What the fuck? Sci-fi.
Five seconds.
Fucking hate this game.
Now, before you say what you think, Reuben, well, you never asked if it was 2010. You said it was 2010 or forward, and then when you started narrowing down those years...
But I narrowed it down up here. I said, did it come out 2015 or later?
Yeah, we said no.
Yeah, so then I said 2014, 13, or whatever.
12.
You never said
2010.
Fuck me.
That's why we're like, no, you haven't asked that yet. And you're like, yeah, I haven't asked them all. Room, what did you think it was?
I didn't narrow it down specifically, and disregarding the date, my mind was going somewhere between The Matrix and Inception.
It was Inception.
Fuck.
So
the sci-fi threw me off. I'm thinking like, what sci-fi with aliens or whatever? I would have thought that's like suspense.
It's classified
or...
as an action adventure science fiction film. Those are the three genres IMDb gives.
Sci-fi just means like weird science shit.
Yeah,
going on.
You don't have to get
thinking aliens.
Reuben, are you ready?
Absolutely not. But let's do this.
Okay, so if Reuben can get this at all, whether it's one question or 20, he wins this round, and we're going on to the next game.
Mm-hmm.
So.
3, 2, 1, go.
Is it animated?
No.
Is it fantasy?
Yeah.
Let me...
Sorry,
That's a confident answer.
Let's just say I meant the genre fantasy.
It's not listed in the genre, I'll say that.
No.
Okay, so it's not in the genre, not in the lore, that's the three that's left.
The last three. Is it fictional?
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay.
Taylor's counting on his fingers for the viewers that can't see. He's very worried.
Male lead?
Yes.
I don't even need this. You know, let's keep track of my... Is it 2010 or later?
No.
Ooh. Is it later than the 90s?
So like 1999 and on, that's what you're saying?
1990, 2000.
Oh, sorry, 1990 and on. Yes.
Smart is not enough. Has it won any Academy Awards?
Yes.
No rush, Reuben. You can take your time.
You can. You have 8.5 minutes.
Is sci-fi in the genre?
Yes.
Ooh. Is there time travel? It's a movie, I know. Academy Awards. Okay, I should specify. Did it come out in the 2000s?
No.
Okay, so it's definitely a 90s movie.
Halfway through this question is 10 left.
In a clean 7 minutes.
Mm-hmm.
55 seconds this week.
Yep. I don't care if I lose, so, you know, it's all good. I'd like to get it, though.
This is a Hail Mary, so...
Are there monsters in this movie?
No.
Is there a heavy use of vehicles?
I don't know.
Vehicles are used, but not a heavy use. Like, not... This is not a movie. It's not like Fast and Furious. It's not a main use.
Is it based on a comic series?
No. 7 left. But I do like the strategy. He could ask all his questions in like 9 and just think about it for the remaining time.
That, you know, sometimes I want that.
No, some, because your mind...
Doesn't do good places. For me.
I don't think yours was by design.
It's my design.
Very thinking hard about these questions. He knows this is.
Well, when you don't write them down, they're all in your brain. You mm-hmm. can't just quickly look at the board, right?
That's true. It's a do or die moment. What are we looking at time wise, Dylan?
We are looking at a clean 6 minutes and 10 seconds.
It's almost a minute for every question, isn't it? Almost.
That's good.
Is there a main villain in this movie?
Yes. Okay, there's still countdowns. He's very, very worried.
We're down to how many questions?
Worried. 6. He has 6 left.
Are there aliens?
No. 5 left. Well, actually, if it's a tie, then I guess it won't help us either way.
If he loses this, it's just void, like.
It is.
So we'll have to go to another game.
It is. But hopefully he can get a point.
Why did it have to have sci-fi in it?
Doesn't feel good, does it?
No, I didn't grow up watching a lot of sci-fi.
I did, but it still fucked me over in the end.
4 minutes and 40 seconds.
Shit.
Is it set in the future?
I think so.
Kind of?
Kind of.
That's a nice answer. I like it.
Hmm. It's a tough. I would still say no as far as just no. Like, it's not like.
It's a no, but like.
Is the main character augmented in a way that he's like more powerful than he should be?
Yes. You have three left.
I don't keep track of when movies come out, so the whole year thing, I'm struggling.
It
but when I was a little kid, you know, I'd watch movies from the 80s and the 70s, so that's just fucking me up right now. But main guy's augmented. Terminator?
No.
RoboCop?
No.
Shit.
Holy fuck.
One more.
The hairs on my neck stood up when you said RoboCop.
So, he used his last two questions. Instead of asking for information, he used them on movies.
Yeah.
So now...
You got a clean 3 minutes to think about what you've just done.
Yeah.
Wow, thanks.
So
yeah.
Three minutes, I feel punished. This is the fate. This is either going to, I guess, be a void, and Ruben will have a lot harder time to climb into the championship, or he can get it on this one and get a point and get back in the game. Next two games, and that would be two, right?
We
so you guys will probably pick this
then
one.
Whoever wins the last game gets to pick one of the older games to go back to and rechallenge.
We're gonna give you two new movies. That's what we're gonna do.
we could do this all night then.
We make the rules. Next one will be 5 minutes if we have to go Sunday.
Yeah, of course.
Mm-hmm. We should both pick movies for each other that we know we've the other seen.
You should think
this discussion has taken you a whole other minute, and now you're done 2 minutes.
Mm-hmm.
Oh boy.
Think hard and get it, because then you don't have to go more
into
this. You want to get this.
Mm-hmm.
This is a first time, Geek Gauntlet fans. We're making rules up as we go. This is the first time.
Because we can do what we want.
It's either a movie I've never seen, or I'm going to hear the title and feel disappointed in myself and my future children.
Mm. Wow. Well, you have two
poor
you have,
children.
What, a minute and a
so
half? You have a minute and a half to decide that?
To not disappoint your children.
We're going to look at two others just in case we need them.
This guy.
A minute and a half.
This championship is mine.
That was a little creepy.
Oh, yeah.
How much time do I have?
1 minute, 60 seconds on the clock.
It's tough when you get in the hot seat.
I'm not worried about the time.
Oh. Wow.
The time's worrying about you.
God, I wish I got like a hint or something. It's so nice.
You had 19.
Yeah, you have 19. 30 seconds.
Still say for that 30 seconds, just pick the best guess and hope for the best.
So I don't have any other guesses for those genres and answers.
Taylor,
you have any idea?
10.
The Matrix?
It is.
Holy shit, what? No.
Yeah, it
no.
is. It's 100% The Matrix.
I was not even thinking about that, because I thought about this last game. Holy shit!
Mm-hmm.
Fuck off.
It
yes!
Was the
what a clutch. It was The Matrix.
Yeah.
That was actually pretty good.
Oh,
that
fuck!
The judges over here talked about switching it, because at one point Reuben said it was Inception or The Matrix, and we thought about it, we said no.
No, that threw me off really hard.
Yeah, that's what I thought.
We picked him beforehand, so we just...
Yeah, we picked him
as
fucking foul play at hand.
There was no... There was no way that I was going to think those two movies. I'm like, no. No.
So Ruben has gained a point, 2-1. He's still
How much time did I have left there?
Like 9 seconds.
So here we are, round 4. A miraculous last second Matrix call up by Ruben lands him here.
Crazy. That was one of the craziest comebacks I've seen, actually.
That was nuts. Alright, so they're hopping right into it.
So, they're playing 3 rounds of this, correct?
They do not want to reply.
No,
so.
They're mad at the commentators. Especially Taylor. Taylor's really salty. He thought he could do it.
Who's top? Who's bottom?
I'm bottom.
Okay.
I mean, in the game.
So, first 100 kills or points or whatever it is wins.
Yeah. Oh, there he has some contact. Taylor took out Reuben, I guess.
So, who's up by 5 right now?
Well, it must be Taylor.
You think so?
Well, he just killed Reuben, so.
Fair enough, yeah.
I think you gotta pick up those tokens in order to get points, but I could be wrong.
Is that true? You have to pick up the tokens? Okay, so there you go. You have to kill them, pick up the tokens. It's been a while since I played Battlefront.
Yeah.
This is Taylor.
Reuben caught off guard, but he's trying to make it away.
Oh. I thought that was almost a mistake taking him on.
Oh, now look at this. Reuben has more.
So, Taylor is a bit more experienced
in
Battlefront. Loves the game, played it a lot.
Right.
Reuben has died again. Taylor's going for it. Ooh, up by 10, so you get 5. That's quite the powerful token.
So we'll just do a best one then, I suppose.
Yeah.
Could take 5. That'll probably be nice if you die.
So yeah, they are. Whoever wins this will get the next point, just so you know, gentlemen. Taylor.
First of 20 kills, essentially. I think that's the only way to get points.
Yeah.
Oh, well, there he. Oh, because you can kill the other guys, too. Okay, and those kills only give you 2 points. So, yeah, I wonder how the strategies will evolve, because obviously you get more points for killing the opposed person, but you get free kills on the computers.
Reuben with his first kill on Taylor, to take note.
Up
so
up to 7 points on Reuben, Taylor at 12, so he's up essentially 1 full kill on the other guy. It looks like they're grabbing some power-ups. Thermal imploder, I don't know what that does.
I love power-ups.
Sounds pretty badass.
I bet it's a thermal that implodes.
I would say you're probably right.
They're very... I have to say that I think this is the most quiet column that we've ever had. Maybe it's because they're both intense and they both want one, but sometimes there's still some trash
talk.
You
mean between the players?
Between the opponents, yeah. Like, they are very focused. Taylor is...
Well, I think this is a very big match. For different reasons, you know. Taylor doesn't want to risk it to get the Goldeneye, where Reuben has bested another weak first opponent before, right? And Reuben knows that he needs this win, or else he's out, obviously.
Yeah, and his undefeated streak is over, which...
That's,
something the fans maybe speculated may never end. You know, he had a dominant run.
The fans have speculated that.
Yes.
There's been rumors.
So, what do we got right now? So, Reuben's
at a clean 13. But
Taylor's 23.
Taylor's up. Oh, but I think he's
trying to save it. Oh! 2 points save. Reuben save points. Big haul. And he got one. I don't know how much it was. He upped 18.
That's good. Good for him.
So there is more than just having to kill one another in this
game. I think you can get
win.
Style points.
Yeah.
Oh. Ooh. But Taylor is just destroying Reuben the 1v1. I think Reuben might be a little too focused on trying to get points elsewhere. Whereas Taylor realizes you get the most points from killing the opposing player character, so it's good to just hunt him down, I guess.
And Taylor seems to be maybe getting killed every once in a while, but he hasn't let go of the lead yet. It's 18-32. He has a good lead on him right now. If he can continue that, he's on his way to victory, which I would be shocked. I'm still shocked we're in this position where I thought Taylor would be fighting from the bottom all the way.
Oh, and that's a grenade.
Oh!
We got another battle going on.
Reuben's taking a lot of damage. Reuben's AI is jumping in there. There's a token there. Reuben's trying to get 2 points saved. Oh! 5 points picked up, 23-32. Oh man, 2 points picked up. Rueben just picked up 7 points back.
That was
back.
That was a big swing of points right there.
Now that's Taylor is scaring him away.
Down to 3 HP.
Oh,
he just got taken out by a miscellaneous computer there.
Oh wow.
Taylor will still get all the points for that though.
5 points.
Another four.
Wow.
Somewhere in
there. That's the thing in this.
Taylor's
game.
Up to
wow.
41. He's almost at the halfway mark.
That's the thing in this game, the lead can change quickly, but you can also gain ahead really quickly, like get up further.
Yeah.
And that's what just happened with Taylor. Rueben was close to tying him, and then Taylor just caught.
Well, here's the thing. Rueben right now, he's sniping guys. Not a great strategy, because if you get distracted and you don't have time to go pick up the points, then you just spend all that time fighting a guy that you're not going to get points for.
Two more points for Taylor Field. Taylor Field's up at 45 out of 100. Rueben's 27. I think Rueben's going to have to change something up or bring his... a different type of A game here.
Well, because here's the thing, right? Like, if they choose to just fight computers from now on and get their points that way, Taylor's gonna win that every day, right?
Mathematically.
If he wants to, he can play chicken and just run away from him and just play that game out, time him out essentially.
Yeah.
I don't think that's Taylor's intention, but
no.
Right now Taylor's got a weapon that's glitching out on the screen, that's for sure. Oh! This could be a trade kill.
Oh, but he put the shield
nice.
Up right before
wow.
he was about to die. It's a Mexican stand-up right here. There's a grenade
and
that's
he's going
thrown.
In.
Oh man, he's all the way healed. Doesn't see where
Taylor
Rueben
doesn't
is.
See Rueben.
Oh, Rueben's stay. Oh!
Oh, he's right beside
you!
Oh my god.
What a comeback from Taylor Field! He was near death. Rueben had him on the ropes. Oh my god.
Because that shield, he can choose when to activate that, right? I think he outplayed him there.
Yeah, Taylor is on a roll right now. He's
52,
on fire.
27
over halfway there.
And here, Taylor is just picking up. Oh, Rueben's on him.
But with the shield.
More shields.
Taylor is timing those shields, and it's hurting
Rueben.
Oh! He caught Taylor though with a headshot!
Nice shot.
5 points picked up.
That's what you
2
need.
Points. There you go.
Up to 34.
That's
he's
what
catching
we like
up.
To see. He's catching up. It's not over yet, folks.
But it is still heavily in Taylor's
face. It is, but we have seen comebacks this whole season happen. So
it's true, they can always happen.
And Rueben is a very skilled individual. I wouldn't put it past him. Taylor Field, we've seen, can get a little cocky. Look at Pokken. He was up right away and he started to fall back. He still won it, but Taylor can get a little confident with himself too much.
But, I mean, I don't know. He played it safe in Mario Kart, though, and that worked out.
He did, so.
It shows that he has. He's got dynamic play styles.
Oh, Rueben with a big shot. Look at Taylor. He's down to 24. Can Rueben capitalize on this? Taylor's running away.
Going into the Cave of
full
Wonders.
House. Cave of Wonders. Here we go.
It's like more power-ups getting picked up.
Rueben's going in there with an
charge
AI
pickup.
Right now. He's I won't reveal what he's at because I don't want to... I'll do it. They're both at 100.
So there you go.
Ooh.
Looks like they're both nearby, but they just can't quite locate it, right? It doesn't look like you have... Is the guy on the radar? It's kind of hard to tell if they're on the ground too, right?
I think maybe when they shoot?
Yeah, maybe.
Oh, now
I don't know where the computers are. I haven't seen any computer players for a while.
Rueben has picked up an item of his own that he can use. Now, I believe there's only 10 minutes in this, correct, Taylor?
I don't know. I didn't see a timer. Mm.
The timer looks
It just
to
keeps
be...
going up. It's not timing down.
I think it's 8 minutes?
It's at 8 minutes now, but it's not timing
down.
But I
think that's about to be over right now, and I think Taylor Field... No, it just...
Keep going. It just... Going. Okay, it's just a weird looking ball.
I guess that's supposed to signify the minute.
Yeah, it is, yeah.
So I imagine 10 minutes, but I don't know for sure. But Taylor's closing in
fighting
on 100.
Some computers, getting the free points.
64 to 34.
It seems like Taylor's just content, like, I don't need to fight him, because that's his only chance of getting back into it. I can just kind of play safe, keep my point advantage.
He's a whole...
Save some points.
32 points ahead.
Yeah, I don't know how you get that back.
It's very tough. Oh...
Grenade launcher's out. Rueben's down 50 health.
Taylor, though, is hunting him down. He's not playing it safe, as much as we think he could.
I've always got the feeling that
points,
Taylor is very much influenced by the commentators.
Mm-hmm.
We are right behind him.
Yeah.
They can't ignore us. We are incredibly annoying. They got to deal with
that. Oh, cannot deploy
nice
here.
Nice shots by Taylor.
Rueben tried something and said he couldn't deploy here. Oh,
wow.
Man. Taylor just
that was
took
just,
him out.
That was clean shots by Taylor.
Oh, my God. He's up to 80. 20. Wait, this?
Crisp, clean lockboarding.
Oh, my God. 85. This is a Taylor Field I honestly don't think we've ever seen before. We have never seen Taylor Field in a dominant position.
He barely knows how to win a 1v1, let alone dominate someone like this.
Oh, I
know. Reuben hasn't gotten a point in minutes.
No, it's been quite a while. I almost feel like Taylor Phil has used up all his frustration from this whole season, and he's using it in this moment.
Up angst,
yeah,
rage.
Exactly. He's here at the Geek Main
Event. The dragon is brewing in his cave.
91.
Orville Strike.
I think it's
Taylor's down, but he's got that shield. I don't know how he keeps finding that shield. Yeah.
Oh, Reuben's in the shield though. Oh, but it's almost like Taylor maybe baited
Reuben's
him.
Down 2 health.
Oh my god. Taylor's at 91. Oh, I think it's over.
96. Game.
Ladies and gentlemen, your winner and still GeekVerse Gauntlet champion, Taylor Field. Oh, doesn't. Wow. There you go. You're still the champ.
I. There was no questions asked, no. Reuben, you know, we play a lot of games together. You're a great contender, and I was a little bit worried, but as soon as I got that sweep at the beginning there, I just started to think, no, things are falling into place. From here on out, Mario Kart's out of the way. It's just games that I know that I can take you on out.
Sure. Well, Taylor, celebrate your victory. I'm going to sit down with Reuben first and interview him. You don't go anywhere because you are going to, well, get out of the chair. Still doesn't listen. Reuben, how are you feeling?
Horrible. That was awful.
What, this or just this whole experience?
Well, I did have fun, but this game, fuck, I hate this game. This is not one of my favorites. This is not one of my not-so-favorites. This is just trash. I hate it.
So I think that with the ladder match, when that happened, those were all randomized. You got a lot of games that helped you and you were good at, but this is the complete 180. You can see what happens. You can get a game like this, like, what else did you guys play? What else did they play?
Mario Kart.
Well, what was the other one in between? Okay. Pokken. You know, you can get games that favor the opponent more. What do you think hurt you the most? Do you think it was the games you didn't play? Do you think it was... Do you think maybe you got a little overconfident? Because you were 5-0. You beat, other than myself and Tyler, you've beaten everybody in the GeekVerse Gauntlet. You had a very impressive debut. You came in. A lot of fans almost like didn't think you could be beaten, especially Taylor, who's had a spotty track record. Was it the games? Were you overconfident? What was it? What was it, the suit? Did the fingers get in your way? What was it? Was it a collection of things?
I think it's just that Taylor and I are so close in competitive games. Mm-hmm. But Mario Kart, if I didn't lose that, I think we'd still be on track. And that's what turned it around, because Battlefront is definitely his game.
Mm-hmm.
First-person shooters outside the older ones like Halo or Goldeneye. You know, the newer stuff, especially Battlefront and Call of Duty, I'm horrible at those.
Mm.
Those are not the games I would ever beat somebody at.
Well, it was a good season. I'm very happy that you're around. I think you're very much like Tyler. I think you have championships ahead of you. I hope you want to stick around in the league.
Oh yeah, I want revenge. I'm pissed at this man over here behind the camera here. He's smiling, he's smirking at me right now.
This nice championship belt here.
Oh.
We all have bad losses, and I think this is just one bad loss. I think you're going to come back better and stronger next season. I'm looking forward, especially as the owner. I'm excited to have someone like you on the roster now. I'm excited to see what you can do, and hopefully you can work your way up back to get a title shot. So thank you very much for this season, Reuben. I am legitimately in shock. Taylor, this has been quite a journey. Talk about just even your journey from the initial GeekVerse Gauntlet tournament, you were last. And then when the league started up, you went on a 5-7 losing streak of single games. And people, like, we all of us really questioned if you could ever even win anything. Smash happened. You kind of maybe were fraudulently won that. But a lot of people, and even myself, who hates your guts, did not give you a chance in this. What is this like, your journey, your whole time? You're ending the season as the champ. You started at the bottom, and now you're here. How does that feel?
You know, a lot of it's surprising, but it feels pretty good. I mean, in the, like, at the beginning of the Gauntlet, you know, it sucked. When you lose a few times, then it starts to really nag at you. You stay down there, and, you know, that came over into the league a little bit there, and as you could see, it stuck with me, but I just had to keep playing. I had to suck up the fact that, you know, I'm losing, but that's okay because I know I'm a good gamer, and finally I got to really demonstrate it and showcase that. And it had to be Reuben. I mean, like, of all the people, me and him have a huge history of doing competitive games against each other, and that's what happened. And I find it very interesting that he beat so many of the geeks where I lost, and then I was able to beat him. It's a very weird balance in the system here, I have to say. But it feels good to be ending on a high note where things are going to change. I'm going to start exerting my power as a competitive gamer here into GeekMania and other tournaments that come in the future.
Well, I was going to say it was very impressive. I said on commentary, I've not seen a dominant state from you like that before. You know, I'm very impressed with you, but yet at the same time, I'm still not a fan of you holding this. As the new owner, I'd much rather have Reuben, I'd much rather have other people as the top of the league. I want to bring in your opponent for the beginning, next season, other opponent. future opponent. Season 2, whenever that starts, Dylan Muss is finally getting his rightful shot. He's the next number one contender. How do you feel about Dylan Muss?
You know, we've had a couple kind of loosey games here. Like, we've been on teams a couple times.
You've never faced one-on-one.
Really?
Never one-on-one. It's going to be a first-time ever match.
You know, we're just going to have to see what game is drawn in the end. It comes down to the game, and then after that, it's up to how well the person plays. Dylan is an incredible gamer. We've done teams and stuff like that.
We've done teams.
I'm looking very forward to a first 1v1 against you. This will be very interesting, but I'm not going to give this up easily.
Dylan, how do you feel about your opponent next season? You have a few months to prepare for Taylor Field. How do you feel about his win today? And then how do you feel about your future matchup with him?
Well, here's the thing. Taylor got this title in a very fraudulent way. Let's go all the way back to a Smash game between six people. It was a six-player free-for-all. And everyone knows that wasn't a free-for-all. It was a 5-versus-1. Everyone was trying to beat me. And I mean, it worked. I only got one game, and then, you know, I couldn't do the 5-versus-1. It's just impossible. It's too much weight on someone's shoulder, you know?
Very true.
And you know who luckily skeeved his way through is this guy right here. And you know, I was here, I was commentating all these matches. I don't know, I don't think Taylor played that well. I think Reuben just sucked it hard. I just think he dropped the ball. I don't know if he was nervous, I don't know if it was the gloves that he was wearing, but I don't think Taylor deserves it. And I think I'm going to prove that when we have to face one-on-one. Name a game, I don't care, anyone. And even if Assassin's Creed doesn't have multiplayer, I would beat you in that anyway.
Wow.
So, I want to lay this out to you, gentlemen. You're going to have your final last words. Taylor, if you defend successfully against Dylan, you break my record of being the longest reigning champion of all time. And Dylan, if you beat Taylor, you become the first ever two-time GeekVerse Gauntlet champion. Taylor, your final thoughts?
This is not going to be going away easily. I'm going to be holding on to this for a very, very long time. I demonstrated my experience with these games. I bested Reuben at his best game, Mario Kart. He's had a lot of experience with that. And, you know, after a little more practice and a couple more matches, I think that I could best you, maybe even at Melee, if we get the chance around to it.
Oh, wow!
I think that when it comes down to it, I think this is in safe, secure, dominant hands for a good long time.
Dylan Muss, final thoughts?
Well, you know, first of all, challenging me in Melee, I mean, I'm going to hold you to that. We're going to play some Melee now. I mean, I saw you get destroyed by Pan Solo, and that guy was just doing the scrubbiest things I've ever seen. That was no skill involved. He didn't even have to think. He could just slap the controller and you would lose. So, I don't think you stand a chance. I think you realize that you don't stand a chance, and you're just, you know, trying to cover it up and trying to be kind of nice. But, you know, yeah, you're holding it now. It's true. But, yeah, I think everyone knows, including the fans, that this is the last time you're going to hold that belt.
It's only a matter of time.
No. You'll get your chance.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, we thank you for tuning in to Geek vs. Gauntlet, the Season 1, GeekMania. It was a great main event, a great event. Stay tuned in the coming months when Season 2 premieres. We'll be having Taylor Field vs. Dylan Muss, first time ever, Geek vs. Gauntlet Championship. Thank you for tuning in.
There's only one man in this world I wouldn't want to fight. That's me, brother. That's me.
Tyler Briggs takes the first one. Tyler Briggs takes the first
one. Oh, like, they're both, I feel like they're both very even.
Dylan Musk has taken the lead for the first time in this match. It's goaltending. Like, he's the man right now. Like Superman meeting Batman in there right in the middle.
It really comes down to how you.
Oh, man! He backs up a goal into the net. Dylan tries to back up again. Oh, can Tyler save it? No! Dylan. With a huge start. Just domination in that opening.
Wow.
Just like that. Even quicker in 2 seconds. Tyler Briggs scored on Dylan Musk. Tyler Briggs is up by 2. Dylan Musk, what a save. My goodness, I've seen a lot of close calls. This is their last match they're playing of the season. You know this means a lot to them both. Here we go. The nice straight shot. Oh. He missed it. It's time to take advantage. It's looking like it's over. Tyler is taking the lose right here.
I'm never a fan of people disrespecting the handshake.
Sonic with the sick swagging out. That's a little.
I would ask David, but I don't care about things, so.
You know what? This belt.
Wow, they just battered that car. And
the rules are always ever.
Oh, nice turn by Gus.
The rules are all.
It's just all over the place.
Oh.
Kirklin.
You get that comeback, it's even better, right?
Can you get the comeback?
Now, crosses the finish line, just hits the ring.
I feel like not knowing who my opponent be doesn't really affect me at all. It doesn't matter who I'm going to be playing against.
Ladies and gentlemen, introducing Kirklin's opponent, Travis Snell.
Chris.
No! Oh!
Yeah, that's kind of weird. See, it was like pause for like 3 seconds.
Throws
you off.
Very bizarre.
No.
That guy is
fast.
That one?
Travis Snell, baby!
I don't know where you got the other one.
Oh
my god!
Let's go!
Wow.
Fuck!
That's what happened.
Come on, baby.
Soccer.
So how do you win?
You win. You basically want to just. I think you want to knock down the other person.
So knock him out. What do you think? So?
Oh
yeah!
Oh yeah! Yeah.
Not cool.
Anything to win. You hear that, ladies and gentlemen?
Oh! 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 What?
And you know, whatever, Kirklin showed that he's a great competitor, but you know what? He wasn't better than the best. I think that.
Okay, here we go. Taylor is very unpredictable. The controls are very.
No! Cool. For the first time, Taylor Phil is taking the lead in this race. This could be a good match for the Mario Kart round.
My god!
And I believe this was Taylor's map pick, so this is a good thing.
Wow. So Taylor Phil is up.
You can definitely see that because obviously Taylor is a veteran. This is it right here.
Wow! Taylor has taken Mario Kart, I think, in
a clean
duel.
Wow, Taylor, look at that smile he just showed.
That's not a smirk. That's a full-on evil, menacing smile. Six? One.
No, the grab.
There's first round. Taylor can do some pretty wild things right now. Something he's just got.
Oh, that's a good show. Taylor's not looking good. Wow. Reuben takes that round. Let's see.
He likes that bunker off.
I am the bunker. Reuben is very close.
But look at this combo.
Wow.
Like he is all over Taylor.
Oh
right
man,
now.
Is
that
close?
All it takes though?
Wow. Oh wow, Taylor Field.
Come on, babe. Let's do this. Is it 2010 or later?
Vibes ready.
Fucking hate this game.
It was Inception.
Let's do this.
Yeah. 10.
Is it the Matrix?
Holy shit, what? No.
Yeah,
no.
It's
no. What was, how much time did I have left there?
Like 9 seconds.
Here we are, round 4.
But Taylor is just destroying Reuben.
Oh,
could be a trade kill.
Oh, but he put the shield up right before he was about to die. It's a Mexican stand-up right here. There's a grenade.
And he's
that's
going.
Oh man, he's all the way healed. Doesn't see where
Taylor
Reuben
doesn't
is.
See Reuben.
Oh, Reuben stay. Oh,
he's here beside
you.
Oh my god.
What a comeback from Taylor Field. He was near death. Reuben had him on the ropes.
By Taylor.
Reuben tried something and said, you know, the boy here. Man. Taylor just took
just,
him out.
That was clean.
He's got that shield.
I don't know how he's playing that shield.
Oh, Reuben's in the shield though. Oh, but it's almost like Taylor being baited in it. Oh my god.
Game.
Champion, Taylor Field. Oh,